prominence, and now stands poised to reach for title and beyond. Ranked third in the land, thanks in part to a quarterback who's their undisputed leader. Now the Cornhuskers have reason to dream of another championship. With special teams play that truly is, and a dominating defense that's met all comers head on. Next collision, Colorado. Sun-drenched Folsom Field in Boulder, Colorado. A sellout crowd on hand for a matchup of two Northern Division rivals in the Big 12 as we get set to see the third-ranked team in the country on the road one more time. Today, they meet the Buffaloes of Colorado. Hi again, everybody. I'm Brad Nessler. Happy holidays. This game is anything but leftovers, especially for Nebraska. So much at stake in their matchup with Colorado, and they have owned the decade. They've lost only once to the Buffaloes over the course of the 90s, and of course, they have three national championships mixed in there. They still have hopes for another one. My partner's Bob Greasy. Here's two teams that have had plenty of time to get ready for this game. They're healthy for the most part, and they've got two red-hot quarterbacks.
In my opinion, the top two quarterbacks in the Big 12, and Brad, they get it done in different ways. Barry Crouch and Nebraska, no surprise, it's on the ground. When I tell you that a quarterback leads Nebraska in rushing, that tells you a lot. He gets my vote for the MVP in the conference, Eric Crouch. Mike Machete, on the other hand, it's through the air. It's a West Coast offense. I like everything I see about this kid. Good percentage, good yardage. The only thing I don't like is the high percentage of interceptions. He has to play well today, and they have to get him off to a good start. It's very important that Machete gets off to a good start.
Machete says he's still haunted by Clint Finley's interception for a touchdown that led to a two-point win for Nebraska a year ago. But for Nebraska, how much is riding on this game? Try everything. The North Division standings in the Big 12 look like this. Kansas State can only sit and wait. Nebraska can win it if they can beat Colorado. And is there a bigger fish to fry? You never know. Virginia Tech playing as well today. Nebraska trying to move up in the BCS standings. So here comes Frank Solich and Nebraska. They'll play Colorado when we come back. Back in Boulder, we get set for the Buffaloes and the Cornhuskers. Third man on our team today, Steve Seifer. Steve.
Thanks, Brad. You know, the one thing Nebraska says it will try not to think about today is what everybody else is thinking about. The Huskers holding on to the football. 39 times this season, the Huskers have fumbled. They've lost 18 of them, the most in the nation. Fumbles cost them the game at Texas, but it's been a problem throughout the season. In their last game against Kansas State a couple of weeks ago, they fumbled a school record 10 times and lost three of them. So how do you stop it? Well, head coach Frank Solich says, one, you do not overemphasize it, but you do continue to stress technique and practice. And then you hope. Brad?
I know that Frank's doing some hoping right now, and what a season he has put together. It is just his second year, 18-5 and 14-1 against unranked teams, but has his team in a position to win the Big 12 championship. On the other side, Gary Barnett in just his first year as the head man here at Colorado, but a longtime assistant under Bill McCartney. And he has put this game back as what they call a red-letter game, Bob, in the Colorado schedule.
Well, Colorado has not won this game in the last 8 years, and I think the underdog kind of does that. They make it a big red-letter game, a rivalry. They want to emphasize it, where when the other team's winning, they don't. It's no big deal. Let's just go down there and win.
Colorado keeps getting closer every year. The past three seasons, 2 points, 3 points, 5 points. So the last three have been decided by only 10. And last year they came oh so close, and in 97 that Nebraska win kept their national championship drive alive. So Colorado almost stalled the championship hunt for them 2 years ago. They hope they can do that again today. Colorado won the toss and deferred. So Nebraska will get its hands on the football first on this glorious Friday. We've had a cold week, some snow in the Denver and Boulder area, but it's all cleared off, melted off, and we got a fast track for Ben Kelly and company for Colorado. Joe Walker and Randy Stella await the kick. The Colorado fans are ready. Aldrich Pooch kick. And a Let's see who it's covered by at midfield. Flags down. I don't believe it went the 10 yards it needed to go. So on the opening kick, they try to come up with a pooch onside kick to try to get their hands on the ball.
Well, Brad, I think it went 10 yards, but one of the guys went down and blocked before the guy tried to have an opportunity to catch the football.
There's the knuckleball, and
there's the block right there.
You're right.
Disregard the flag, no foul. The ball hit the ground, no fair catch interference. First down, Nebraska.
So Nebraska has great field position to start with, right on the Colorado side of the midfield stripe. Gary Barnett did that at Northwestern. I think it was against Wisconsin when he was a head coach at Northwestern.
Well, he told us, he says, we have a lot of ammo. We had 2 weeks to load up the wagons. He says, we're going to fire every bullet here today. He's already fired a huge one.
And it gives Nebraska a great field position. Eric Crouch, Dan Alexander's the eye back. He's fumbled on his first carry the past 2 weeks. Not this time, at least so far. And he's got a head of steam. Alexander trying to tiptoe the sideline. He's still on his feet. He might take it. Touchdown, Nebraska.
Oh, the difference of a couple weeks.
50 yards on the first carry, and Nebraska in the end zone.
2 weeks ago, he fumbled the first carry. Today, he runs it in for a touchdown. And watch, they don't want Crouch to get the ball and to keep it, so a quick hit on Crouch leaves the back open. The I-backs for Nebraska have not produced this year like they have in the past, but they produced right there on the opening play of the game.
Josh Brown for the point after, and just like that, we've had two plays, an onside kick attempt, one play by Dan Alexander, taking it down the sideline, the junior 50 yards for a touchdown. Quite what Colorado had planned 15 seconds into the game, down a touchdown. Dan Alexander, when we talked to Frank Solich the other day, we said, how's he doing? He says he just got to get his confidence back after all the fumble problems. So that's the way to get it back. One play, one touchdown.
Got to be a big boost for Alexander.
Ben Kelly, two touchdowns on returns this year. They'll try to keep it out of his hands.
Well, they're not going to kick it to him. They're going to pooch it or try and kick it. There's a pooch.
A high, shorter kick. Kelly's going to try to make a play on it. Actually, he fights with his teammate. And Roman Hollowell takes it away from him. We got a penalty marker down at the 27-yard line.
Roman Hollowell on the return for the Buffaloes.
So Kelly was going to have none of that, even though Hollowell ended up with the ball. He came over and tried to swipe it from it. John Lurie's our referee. It's a holding call against Colorado, so they're going to start in a bit of a hole. Our Chile starting lineup. Here's how the group looks up front for Colorado. Johanningmeier was a preseason All-American. Brad Bedell has already made one All-America list. Rogers is back from an injury. Gerard and Cook round out the front wall. Stiggers, tremendous speed. Minardi starts the other side, although Javon Green's a big play receiver in the three wideout group. Andrews is the lead man for Cortland Johnson. Mike Machete is at quarterback, and he is a fiery quarterback, to say the least. And here he comes out with the offense. This start from the 16-yard line. And he starts with three wide receivers. But they'll keep it on the ground, and Johnson gets buried immediately by Steve Warren, and he lost a half yard. The Biggins up front for Nebraska, led by Warren, who leads the team in tackles for loss. He just added another one. Kaiser, Vandenbosch, and Wills on the front four. The linebackers, Ortiz and Jackson outside. Carlos Polk, a bit of an injury, but is playing the inside spot. The secondary, a very tough one. Booker, Brown, Craver, and Ralph Brown. And those two guys, 21 and 22, as good as anybody in the country. Ralph Brown, a great cover man. And now he's in motion with Hollowell. Machete off play action. Running for his life. Got back across the line of scrimmage. Got only about a yard, though. And as Bob told us to open up the game, and Mike Machete echoes, he wants to get off to a good start in this football game.
I've really sat down with the coaching staff and gone over the game plan and really gone over the things that I like and don't like. And so what we're going to try to do early on is throw my the top passes that I like and get into a rhythm. And because I'm a real streaky quarterback, if I can get into a rhythm early, I'll stay in the rhythm all game.
And one of the plays he wanted to run, I got the feeling, was a running play. And that second play of the game, he got hit a little bit and took off running.
Still has a third and 10 to try to pick up here. Blitz. Wobbles it out. It's It's intercepted. No, in and out of the hands of Anenbosch. Or was it Wills? Wills out there, floated out. The defensive end almost picked that pass off.
They did. It was a safe play. He wanted to get into the flow of the game. It was a screen pass. Get a positive play going. Just great coverage by Wills. Pressure on the quarterback up the middle. And he just tried to throw it out of, over his head and out of the out of bounds and didn't get it there because he was getting hit by Jackson, number 50, just as he was throwing it.
So it forces a punt for Colorado behind Nick Peach, who's near his own goal line. And remember, Nebraska has blocked 10 kicks this year. He gets this one off, no trouble. Joe Walker looks up in the sun, and he'll take it at the 40 and goes down immediately. Nice coverage down there by Ben Kelly, the All-American defensive back on the special teams. 44-yard punt, no return. We'll return in a moment with Nebraska and the football back with a touchdown lead. Shetty there, his self-admission that he's a streaky quarterback. He almost saw Nebraska's defensive end streak into the end zone with that last pass.
He has not gotten off to a good start. He's been involved in three plays. He handed one off, but the other two plays where he wanted to get outside and either run or throw wasn't a positive play. And then the last play almost picked off.
So Nebraska, good field position again, leading by a touchdown, starting now from its own 40-yard line. Bobby Newcomb in motion. Miller, the fullback, got about three. Chili starting lineup. The big eaters up front. These guys did some turkey in yesterday. Rayola and Hochstein playing as well as anybody on that front wall with Volk, Sherman, and Jolch. The wideouts, Matt Davison went without a catch a couple of weeks ago when we did Nebraska's game. Tracy Wistrom's their big play tight end. Bobby Newcomb, their wing back. And in the backfield with Eric Crouch and Willie Miller is Dan Alexander, who's touched it once today and taken it 50 yards for a score. He's out right now, and Newcomb is the tailback, and Bobby's in motion out of that backfield. Crouch, quarterback draw. He's got some room. Crouch across midfield. 40. Crouch down the sideline. They don't knock him out until he gets all the way to the 22-yard line. And a late penalty flag. We might have a late hit on the sideline to boot. 35 yards for Crouch. He wants that leading rusher tag back from Alexander, who just overtook him on that one play.
That's true. He's not happy about that, is he? Watch here. Is it going to be a blitz? Both linebackers coming up the outside. The middle linebacker is going to be the only guy left to catch anybody.
Personal foul.
Look right here. The fullback comes through, gets the block on him, and Crouch just reads the block and then takes off to the outside.
And right at the end of the play, there you see the hit by Michael Lewis, and it was a personal foul for the late hit out of bounds, and so you take 35 yards to the 22 and then tack on the penalty yardage down to about the 12.
Yeah, this is not what Gary Barnett had in mind when he said we're going to come out and fire all our bullets. I mean, he came after him. It's amazing the way the offense for Nebraska adjusts to whatever you're doing.
Newcomb in motion, but they give it to Alexander straight up the middle, and he got to the 1 yard line. Playing like an I-back possessed is Dan Alexander right now. He's touched it twice, scored one touchdown, and almost did there.
Well, that's just good running and good blocking by the offensive line. You just introduced him, Sherman and Rayola and Hochstein in the middle there. I mean, this is a huge hole. This is something these guys haven't seen in a while.
They're going to spot it at the 2 yard line. Alexander remains the eye back behind Miller. He'll get the call. Three carries, two touchdowns. Oh, boy.
This looks like the Colorado defense that played the first six games and not the last four, where they've been very good.
They've been dramatically improved from 29 points down to 14 a game. And for the most part, as Bob said, it's been their rush defense, but they're not stopping anybody right here.
Well, Hochstein gets a nice block. Sherman comes around. And it's just, that's a physical battle inside. It's being won right now by the offensive line of Nebraska.
Josh Brown for the point after. London got the hold down. The kick is perfect. And we're only 3 minutes into this football game. It's 14 to nothing, Cornhuskers.
What Gary Barnett has done, and we mentioned it, is put this as a red letter. We want a rivalry here. And when you do that, and he knew this, you put more pressure on your players, but he wanted the pressure on these players. If you're going to play in this conference, you got to play up to the caliber that Nebraska brings. And I think there's a little bit more pressure on the Nebraska players right now playing at home. Sometimes, you know, people think if you play at home, well, you got an advantage. Well, sometimes there's more pressure because of family and the fans. They expect you to play better. And on the team coming on the road, they're closer. They get to better, get to bed together. They're in a hotel. The meetings are tighter, and they come out and play better.
Especially wrapped around a holiday weekend, as this one is. So Crouch in the Nebraska offense has only needed five plays to put up 14 points. Deshaun Sykes talking with Brian Cabral, the linebacker coach over on the sideline. And you know that Colorado defense has got to come up with something in a hurry. And so must their offense not be three and out on this next series. Ben Kelly
for sure
waiting on the kick now. And again, they tried to keep it away from him and kicked the high short kick to Hollowell last time. They'll do the very same thing here. Hollowell looks at Kelly, turns around and says, yours, Ben, at the 10. But he only got to about the 27-yard line. That's where Colorado will go to work, and so will Bob Greasy with our Dell Game Solutions.
Well, as we mentioned a couple of times, Colorado's got to get Machete into the ball game and get him off to a good start. They've only had three plays, but it hasn't gotten off to a good start yet. Defensively for Nebraska, rattle and pressure the quarterback. They've already done that on one occasion, almost sacked him and almost forced him to throw an interception. But the game is still young, and Machete needs to get into the rhythm and get into a groove to get this team turned around. They need some momentum on this drive.
They're going to start at about the 27-yard line. Machete played his final home game, and last year had that interception that Clint Finley took for a touchdown that really was the margin of victory. Those were the numbers, though. He did throw two touchdown passes last year, and he says nobody remembers those. They remember the one they took the other way on me. There's a little bit of Jim McMahon in that kid, if you ask me.
Yeah, there's a little swagger in him. Yeah, you like that. I mean, he's a tough kid. He seems like a street kid, very knowledgeable, and just says, hey, when Gary Barnett came, he says, don't tell me what I'm doing well. Tell me what I'm not doing well so I can work on it and get better.
They're going to run a draw play out of the shotgun of Corlin Johnson. Takes it out near the 30-yard line. Eric Johnson makes the tackle defensively for the Nebraska defense. One of the top units in the country. They don't give you points. They don't give you yards on the ground. You take a look at the NCAA rankings. Number two total. Third in scoring. Only 11 points a ball game. Number two in passing efficiency with that defense that will take your head off if they get a chance.
They've got it all.
Machete. Throws, got a wide open receiver across the 40, and that's Javon Green. Keo Craver was out there, but Javon Green had quite a cushion on him. He's got a first down at the 41.
This is where they have to do their business and get something done, because you're going to have single coverage on the outside receivers. Here he is out here. You got single coverage out here and single over here. He's just going to throw a little out route over here. And this is getting Machete into the ball game. Getting back, completions, move the ball.
Now the fullback, Andrew, trying to bull his way forward. Got to almost the 45. Give him a pickup of four. That's only the second carry for Dave Andrews this year from that fullback spot. He had a pretty good record coming in. One carry, 1 yard, one touchdown. But he got four there.
That may be his last carry of the day,
yeah,
too.
Who knows?
His mama will be glad that you mentioned his name a couple times. But that's what they want to do. They don't want to run east and west against Nebraska defense. They're too quick. Just run right at them and then throw outside.
Cormier comes in as a third wide receiver. Machete, the quick drop and the out to Green. Made an acrobatic catch. Nope, they're going to say out of bounds. I thought he got his foot down. That is right below us, but apparently hit the chalk line. He had to go way up in the air to even have a chance for that.
Single coverage out here. Brown. See, I don't think Machete could see that well.
Ooh, why wasn't that a catch?
Did he have possession of the ball when his foot was inbounds? That's the question. I don't think Machete could see very well, because he obviously was open and he threw the ball way high and outside.
Unless I missed something. That was
catch. His foot was inbounds.
Absolutely. Not even close. Hollowell in motion. on a third down. Machete rolls to throw. In trouble. He's got to let go of it. Too much pressure. Carlos Polk came in there and leveled Machete as he let go of the football.
Now this is one of the bread and butter plays for the Buffs, and I'm sure that the Huskers have worked on this all week. Just a sprint out. Quarterback takes the ball, sprints out. The back there doesn't get a good job on Wills, and Polk just comes through scraping and put the pressure on him. And there was nobody open downfield, and he just had to throw it away.
I think Machete was complaining that somebody was held downfield where he was trying to throw. Peach to punt, and Joe Walker waits on the other end. Great coverage last time by Ben Kelly, one of the gunners out there on the coverage. Walker runs up on this one. I think he might have lost it in the sun. Has to back out of there, and it's down by Damon Wheeler on the special teams at about the 19-yard line. Eric Crouch already got a 14-point lead to work with. Defense right now is looking at giving up 20 yards a carry so far to Nebraska in this football game. And they're down in a hole, 14 to nothing. Cornhuskers from their own 19. Davis in a single wide out, and it's a fullback Miller, and he blasts out to the 26-yard line, a pickup of almost 7. Defensively for Colorado, the Chili's front four. Bannon playing very well in there with Warren McDonald and Fred Jones, their rush in. The linebackers, Ty Gregorak missed the last game. He's back now. Sykes, their big play man, and Drew Walruse. And in the secondary, Barnes and Lewis are the safeties. Damon Wheeler and Ben Kelly are the corners. Kelly, an All-American on one list already this year, and as you saw, a great return man as well. Second and four. Alexander on the pitch. This time Colorado's got it read pretty well. Brady McDonald makes a big play.
Yeah, the first positive play, either offensively or defensively, for the Buffs. And they need something to help turn them around. Inside there, Bannum and Warren, the two defensive tackles, getting some mixing it up in there and allowing some of the other guys to get in there and make a play.
And finally, they force Nebraska now into a long yardage situation on third down. Third down and 7. Davison and Newcomb, the two wideouts, both to the near side. Bobby Newcomb back in motion toward the ball as Crouch pumps once and fires the out. He's got Davison across the 40 and out to the 45. First down, Cornhuskers. Run out of bounds, but not before he got a first down at a pickup of 24.
This is the thing that's so impressive about Eric Crouch. You force him into third and 7, and he still completes. He's going to go down here and just break to the outside. You know, third and 7 for Nebraska is not real long, but Crouch, he gets it done running, and he also drops back and throws the ball. He's ranked first in the Big 12 in pass efficiency. He hasn't thrown enough passes to rank nationally, but he's very efficient.
Getting better every week. First down at the 45. At the middle with Miller again. They're using the fullback quite a bit here early in the game. Got almost 3 yards. 8:35 remaining in this first quarter that's belonged to the Cornhuskers of Nebraska. On the very first play from scrimmage, Dan Alexander took it from the midfield stripe to the goal line stripe. Touchdown Nebraska in one play. They led 7-0. And then Alexander from 2 yards out following another short Nebraska drive. And that's where we stand right now. And they are approaching midfield again with a second down and 8 upcoming. Frank Solich looking on, his third-ranked Cornhuskers leading 14-0. Davison in motion with 3 wideouts to the left. Here's a slip screen run out of the hands of Bobby Newcomb.
Looking through it just a little bit hard. Let's go to the Dell Game Solutions, Brad. And for Nebraska offensively, they got to eliminate, reduce the turnovers that have been bugging them all season long. Reduce them, not eliminate them, just cut them back, and then crank up the run, which they've already done. And defensively for Colorado, take Crouch out of the running game. They've done that so far, but Alexander and the other guys have got it.
That's right. You plug one leak and water comes through somewhere else. Yep. 3rd and 8. Crouch to throw. Got a deep out. Tipped. Almost intercepted by Wheeler. And intended for Bobby Newcomb. Wheeler says, nope, not on that one.
Great matchups all day long, both sides of the ball, the wide receivers versus the corners. You got some great corners in this game from behind the defense. Crouch with plenty of time to throw, a little semi-roll, puts the ball right on the target, and a good play by Wheeler.
So Ben Kelly drops back inside his own 15. Dan Haydenfeld, one of the better punters in the country, over 44 a kick, set to punt for the first time today for Nebraska. High kick, Kelly waiting on it. He's going to take a shot at it from the four. Dangerous position, but he's got a little bit of room, and he gets out to the 16, maybe the 17-yard line. ABC Sports presentation of college football brought to you by the all-new 2000 Pontiac Bonneville. Luxury with attitude. Burger King, have it your way. Inspired technology with a human touch. Nokia, connecting people. And Dr. Pepper and your local Dr. Pepper bottler. Dr. Pepper, this is the taste. And there's a taste of the beautiful scenery in Boulder, Colorado.
Isn't that gorgeous?
Oh, man. On a splendid day here after Thanksgiving, we welcome you to Folsom Field in Boulder, where the Buffaloes trail third-ranked Nebraska 14-0. Brad Nessler, Bob Greasy, Steve Cyphers, and our ABC crew with you. Play action. Machete wants to go deep on the sideline to Green, and over his head, Ralph Brown was covering and covering well.
They had single coverage. Machete just threw that ball. Green is one of their best receivers. In fact, is their best receiver. He's 6'3 and can jump. And they had him out there single coverage on Ralph Brown. And Machete didn't give him a chance to do something. He just threw it out of bounds.
Ralph Brown's already made an All-American team this week. Started every game of his career. 50 times he's been in the starting lineup.
That's amazing.
It really is. Here's the toss to Johnson. And Johnson only got it out to about the 19 or the 20. Kaiser made the tackle. Getting back to Ralph Brown, you think about 50 straight starts, and he's the first guy since World War II that started the first game of his career and then played every game as a Cornhusker. That's just unbelievable.
I think I did his first game as a freshman. And I know, you know, when the freshman starts at corner, everybody's going after him. And he held up his end of it his freshman year and has gotten better every year.
Third down at 7 now for Mike Machete from the shotgun on a quarterback draw. And Vandenbosch says, I'm going to draw this up for you.
Well, Machete is not having his way. His throws are a little high and a little wide. And the rushing plays that they're trying to get him into the game, there's nothing there.
Right here, he just gets Vandenboshed.
Yeah, Polk number 13, and Vandenbosch did a little cross game, mixed up the blocking assignments, and that's just a little thing that Charlie McBride does, the defensive coordinator.
Peach now inside his own 5-yard line again. Two deep men back, and Walker and Newcomb. Nice kick. Walker's got a back pedal at the 32. And great coverage again by the Buffaloes. That's one thing they're doing very, very well is covering punts, a 52-yard kick, and no return. Tomorrow, Spain's El Nino.
Well, I tell you, I always enjoy watching that. That's always fun.
It'll be a good one tomorrow. We've got a good one here if you're a Nebraska fan, I guess. 14-0, and the Cornhuskers have it back again at their own 33-yard line. Again, they fake that end around and go up the middle to the 38-yard line. Dan Alexander got 5. Andy Peake made the tackle. They keep running Newcomb in motion, and it's just been a decoy so far. One of these times he'll get it on the end around.
Bobby Newcomb, you know, for anybody that doesn't follow Nebraska football, was the starting quarterback at the beginning of the season and played a lot last year as quarterback. He's since been moved. Crouch came in a quarterback, but he's a great athlete on the outside, and everybody knows defensively where he is on the offense.
Second and 5 on the option. Crouch will keep it. Got a nice block from Euler, the fullback, and he might have the first down. Rashidi Barnes finally put number 7 down. Eric's looking over there at that stick as if to say, am I close enough or did I get it?
But what Colorado wants to do defensively to stop Crouch from running the option is mix things up. They want to have somebody tackle him on every play. Here he's going to go down the line.
And a linebacker that's coming into your picture right there, Sykes, is responsible for the quarterback. Another play, it'll be the defensive end. Another time, it'll be one of the defensive backs. So they want to mix it up, trying to stop Crouch from getting the yardage on their options.
Colorado's defense and the rest of the defenses around not only the Big 12, but all around college football. We'll talk about Nebraska having about seven different schemes just of option football. They got so many different things they can do to you.
Yeah. Gary Barnett was telling us yesterday, he says, we got to mix things up because their staff has been together so long that they'll see what you're doing, and they do it. If you just do it one way, then they'll block that way, and they'll be free on it.
Third down in about 3 inches for Nebraska. Crouch wouldn't get much, but he didn't need much. He's got a first down.
I was talking with Milt Tenneper, the offensive line coach for the Huskers, before the ball game down on the field, and we were talking about just that thing. I said, how do you feel? He says, well, we got to get the run game going. He says, we got to find out what they're doing. I said, yeah, I guess you've been through that a few times. Everybody's got a way they want to stop your option. You got to see what they're doing and react to that. Go back to 19 this year and that year and see what this team did against you and then react to it.
Well, you know, a lot of people think Nebraska's had an off year on the ground because they're only averaging 260 yards. They're still sixth best in the country. There is the end around Newcomb. Colorado does a nice job with it, though, and Wheeler whams him out of bounds at about the 47-yard line.
This is one of the ways that Nebraska opens up the field, running a reverse. Here it is right here. He fake it to the fullback this time. Now, Colorado's got pretty good coverage over there, but the next time they bring him back around, you know, they may draw some guys with him. And here's a look at what he has been doing. He was 2-0 as a starter at the beginning of the year.
Eric Crouch played six games in Bobby Newcomb's stead when Newcomb was shaken up last year, and now he is the man at quarterback. And he got hit as soon as he tried to get the pitch. The ball is loose, and Colorado's got it. Big hit by Rashidi Barnes.
The Buffs were up in a blitz situation. And they blitzed and they got a turnover. We told you several times that Nebraska will turn it over. Watch, these guys are going to come up and blitz up in the seams. Moving forward. And he never got the exchange. Crouch saw him coming, tried to get it to him quickly, and he never got the exchange.
So the fumble recovery gives Colorado a good field position to work with now. Finally in Nebraska territory, and they get 3 yards from Cortland Johnson on the first carry. Boy, that defense was just itching for something like that to happen.
Oh, sure. And they know the stats. They know how badly Nebraska turns the ball over. Fumbles. They lead the nation in fumbles and lost fumbles.
So it's their 40th fumble.
Yeah, they're trying to get one, and they did.
There's the numbers coming in, obviously. Johnson hit the backfield by Steve Warren. Big Steve Warren, who last year had some injury problems. His back was bothering him. He gained some weight. He wasn't the player he is now, but he's...
He went into kickboxing.
Yeah.
He tried everything medically. It didn't work, so he just started kickboxing, and that helped his back more than anything.
Yeah, he's kicking around some running backs now around the Big 12.
And that defensive line is dominating all those fine players, that All-American and the guy, the preseason All-American, in that Buffs offensive line right now.
They're shoving him around. Third down and five. Stiggers in motion. Machete, the quick drop, fires, and it's batted down by Carlos Pope, the linebacker. Yeah. Nice drop by Pope, and got up in the air, and it's fourth down.
Pope was kind of questionable whether he's going to play today or not with a high ankle sprain, but Machete is not getting into this game the way he wants to. He's 1 of 5 and not getting into it with the way he wanted to.
With Peach now to punt. Keel Craver waiting inside the 10. Peach would like to drop this punt inside the 10 somewhere. Almost got a hand on it. Was Pope. And this one floats down, bounces at the 1, and into the end zone. With 3 minutes and 45 seconds remaining, nothing going right for Colorado. It's Nebraska by 14.
The talent. To go show what we can do as a new team in a new year. We just got to keep telling ourselves that we can get the job done, and I think we will.
Eric Crouch in Nebraska getting it done so far. Back-to-back weeks as Big 12 Player of the Week for Crouch. And he's got the Nebraska offense set up again at the 20-yard line. On the option. Crouch going to keep this one, and he goes down to the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play. His numbers, though, incredible. He rushed a couple weeks ago when we had Nebraska 27 times, which was a school record for quarterbacks. And there's the rushing yardage and passing yardage in the last two games and the touchdowns he's accumulated. And you and I were talking to him yesterday and said, have you ever run 27 times before? He said, yeah, you know, one or two times at Millard North there in Omaha, I carried it 30 times, but never in college.
He only averages throwing the ball 13 times a game. And he's getting pretty good at that, too. It's about time for a tight end. They watch that wrist. Wister pretty much along the way here.
He's going to keep it again. And a late pitch and a fumble. Out of bounds. Very similar to what we've seen happening all season long for Nebraska, trying to get that extra yardage or wait to that extra split second. And it goes out of bounds, luckily for him.
Eric Crouch is a great runner, probably maybe a better running quarterback than they had at Nebraska in a long, long time. But his decisions on when to toss it and when not to toss it have not been solid. Right there, he either didn't get the good pitch or was a bad choice as to when to pitch the football. Should have just kept it and hung on to it. I think the problem is Eric wants to run the ball first and pitch it second. And then only when his run is not there, he gives up on it.
Crouch, broken field, and into the open field. Eric Crouch, Ben Kelly trying to track him down, and he will. But he got all the way to the 30-yard line. 46-yard run. He does want to run first. I guess I can see why.
Well, Nebraska was coming after him again very aggressively on third down. Look at, there's nobody here in the backfield. There's nobody in the middle of the field. Look at this. Nobody here. All he has to beat is this one man, and he's going to break the tackle. Right up the field, a quarterback draw against a blitz.
And if Ben Kelly's not a track man, that's a touchdown.
Yeah. That's probably the only guy on that defense that could have caught it.
You're exactly right. 91 yards on six carries for Crouch. Now it's Alexander. And he busts in to the secondary. Almost a first down run by Alexander. This is the best we've seen him run in a long time. He got nine.
Just when the Colorado defense looks like they're going to get in control of this offense of Nebraska, they break one. Crouch breaks the draw up the middle. And they haven't contained Alexander yet today.
Alexander's had three 100-yard games this year. He's definitely heading in that direction in the first quarter. 72 yards on six carries. There's his numbers coming into the game. Two more touchdowns already today. Here's a pitch to him. Watches his blockers, and he's down inside the 15 with a first down, Nebraska. 1:41 remaining here in the first quarter. Coming up tomorrow night, primetime college football matchup. Don't miss Rose Bowl bound Stanford, led by their sensational wide receiver, Troy Walters. He'll take on the Fighting Irish of Notre Dame. That comes up tomorrow night, 8 o'clock Eastern, 5 Pacific on ABC Sports, home of the Bowl Championship Series. You get post-game analysis each week, too, from John Saunders online with abcsports.com at espn.com, part of the Go Network.
Stanford scores a lot of points, don't they?
They give up some, too.
They always keep it interesting.
Number 14, Alexander hitting the backfield. Great penetration.
Got hit by
Justin Bannon, who pushed the lineman backward.
Pushed Volk backwards, and Alexander wasn't expecting to get hit that quickly, especially not in his own backfield.
Yeah, friendly fire. Got wiped out by his own guy.
I like that. Watch Volk, 58, right here. He's going to try and cut the lineman off and can't do it. Good penetration.
So Nebraska's offensive tackle has the best tackle of the game so far against Alexander. Drops his own man for a four-yard loss. Two tight ends set now. They haven't gone to Wistrom yet in this game. Second and 14. Crouch scrambling around, and down he goes. Jayshon Sykes got it.
They wanted the shovel pass to the remaining back, and it just wasn't there. The timing wasn't there, and he had to keep it.
And he lost a yard.
He wanted to throw the ball forward to number 38, Alexander. And there was somebody in his way, and he just held on to it, which was a smart move.
And a smart move for Eric Crouch to come to the sideline and talk things over, because the first quarter's come to a close. Nebraska will face the third and 15 when we return. ABC Sports presentation of college football will return after this message and a word from our ABC stations. At the Colorado 18-yard line, third and 15. If they don't pick up a first down, it'll be about a 35-yard field goal attempt upcoming. But let's see what they do offensively with Bobby Newcomb in motion. They're going to throw it out there to him. High, though, and incomplete. Wanted to throw the screen to Newcomb again. Second time today that has not worked. And now Josh Brown will come out. And it looks like it'll be about a 35-yard field goal attempt.
Eric looked like he's run down already. He's
he should be. He's got 90 yards.
90 yards rushing and another... another 24 yards passing.
Josh Brown, 10 out of 15 on the year. As long as you see is 37, so he's right about in that range. They're going to actually spot this at the 24, so it'll be a 34-yard field goal attempt. Frankie London is the holder. Kick by Brown is on the way, and it's perfect. Nebraska's done very little wrong today. And ranked third in the country, leading 17 to nothing. They have put it on the ground a couple times, though, so far, Steve.
With me is Dr. Jack Stark, Nebraska's team sports psychologist. Jack, I understand you've been working with the ball carriers on how to avoid these fumbles.
Yes, when you have a mental slump like we've been in, you follow two rules. You keep it subtle and you keep it simple. Subtle is you have a team meeting, you work on some drills, and you stop talking about the negative. And then you go to the simple. Simple is where you learn to tuck the ball, you have a mental cue where you say tuck, and you watch a lot of visualization, which we work with them all year on, with CDs and visualization tapes.
How was it for Alexander to get the first carry of the game?
Big time, because that gave him a lot of confidence taking it all the way down.
Are you satisfied with the results so far?
Yeah, but we still lost one. I hope now we're going to hope and pray now.
You are the fumble doctor.
Well, I try to do whatever I can.
All right. Thank you, Dr. Stark. Brad?
All right, guys. Well, it's worked so far for Alexander. That one fumble was not his fault. That was the pitch by Eric Crouch, but that one didn't cost him anything. It went out of bounds. I remember a few years ago when John Smoltz was struggling with the Atlanta Braves, and he got basically a sports shrink that is still works with him to this day, and that's gotten him a championship and a Cy Young Award. So that works sometimes.
The Colorado wanted to get started off on a fast track, and they have it. Four possessions. They've punted the ball four times, and the last time they got the ball, they got it in great field position on Nebraska's 47-yard line. So three of the four possessions have been three plays and punt. Machete is one of six for only 11 yards. That's not the start the Buffs wanted.
Yep, if he didn't get better, it's only going to get worse for the Buffaloes today. Charrington checks in a tailback now for Colorado. Marcus Stiggers in motion, and Machete falls down, try to backpedal. May have been stepped on by his center or one of his guards. So it just gets worse for Mike Machete.
You're right, Brad. That's definitely when that happens. One of the guards or center steps on him. And it's not getting any better.
Nope.
I mean, they wanted to throw on first down, which is the best down to throw on. And I think it was the right guard, the strong guard, Bedell.
So another loss of four on the play. Back to near the original line of scrimmage. Warren makes a tackle on Andrews. And it's going to be third down and 11.
The thing about Nebraska defensively is they put you in so many defensive or so many negative plays on first downs, especially. That last first down, Colorado contributed to their own demise. Normally, it's these black shirts of Nebraska defensively that are coming across the line of scrimmage knocking the ball.
Machete going to throw a screen out. Charrington on the run. He's upended by Ralph Brown. Great open field tackle at about the 28-yard line by number 22.
The nice thing about Ralph Brown, Brad, is that, you know, not only is he a good cover guy, but he can come up and tackle. He's a physical corner that can cover and tackle.
Tackled hard enough that Charrington was shaken up on the play.
Nice call, screen pass. Looked like there was something out there, and then Ralph Brown beats the blocks and makes the tackle.
Punting time again for Colorado. And they fake it. Pass complete. First down across the 40 and out to the 49-yard line. Nate White with a reception.
One of the things that that Gary Barnett said, that sometimes they don't always cover the gunners on the outside in the punt formation. And he felt like he needed to take a chance and throw the ball and get him out there.
And Peach does the big Academy Award jump as if the snap was high.
Yeah.
And the pass comes out, Nate Wright takes it for a first down at the 49.
But it's Gary Barnett, he's taking chances. He sees he's down 17 points. He needs to create some momentum and get some of these plays working, and that was a big one.
Let's see if it helps him. Portland Johnson, his best run of the day. Got 5 to the 46. Aaron Wills made the tackle. Second down and 5 coming up, and Colorado back in Nebraska territory.
Defense is just aggressive across the line of scrimmage, tight man-to-man coverage, and they're tough.
Two tight end set. They'll toss it to Johnson following his blockers. First down at the 40. Nice lead block by Andrews, the fullback again. 6-yard pickup, and they'll move the sticks. Colorado's gotten a little bit of something working here.
And what the Bucs have done, they're tossing it like it's going to be a wide play, but they're not running outside the tight end. It's running inside, so they need some offense. They need a ground game to help with the passing game. If Machete only has his passing game, that's not going to cut it against these guys.
Inside the 40 they are with a first down, and Johnson spins his way for 3. Now Vandenbosch and Brown are there to knock him off his feet. Machete looking over to the sideline, getting the call in and hoping that he can get something going with the air game maybe as soon as this next play.
Well, this offense just needs to stay on the field and give a rest to do their defense. They've had the ball 4 possessions and never had it more than 5 plays.
Machete running for his life. Throws incomplete, just got rid of it. Andrews, the closest guy. Aaron Wills, though, is bringing all the heat on Machete. Gary Barnett, as we talked about, a longtime assistant with Bill McCartney, who made the Nebraska game one of the key games for Colorado. And when Gary Barnett took over for Rick Neuheisel this year, he said, we're going to have 2 red letter games, and one of them is right there, Nebraska. And literally a red letter game on their schedule down in the team room. Frank Solich says, everybody's red letter.
Exactly. Everybody is our rival.
Third down and 7. Machete from the shotgun. Has time. Throws complete. Hollowell. And it's a first down. Hollowell in front of Craver. A 9-yard pickup. Finally something to cheer about for the folks at Folsom Field.
Yeah, and he has good protection. Here he is right here. Hollowell just going to down. Run a little curl route. Does a nice job of avoiding the jam. Craver, number 3, releasing, starts from the outside, comes back to the inside.
First conversion of a third down for Colorado. Andrews, the fullback, and he blasts his way down to about the 23. Tony Ortiz is the man that made the tackle. Gary Barnett talked with us about the whole rivalry here in the North Division with Nebraska.
What rivalries do is they just make you operate at a higher level. They just bring more intensity to the game, and it pushes you as a human being. It pushes you as a program. It pushes you as a group of men. Coming back, there wasn't any question that I wanted to charge that rivalry back up, that I wanted it to be back the way it was.
If his team can muster some offense, it would certainly help the cause. Nebraska takes a timeout, and the Cornhuskers lead by 17. Nebraska's dominated the game so far. Dan Alexander, 2 touchdown runs. Colorado trying to fight back in it. The 11th play of this drive. Cortland Johnson. They're just working the middle right now, going straight at the teeth of that Nebraska defense. They've got it down to the 20-yard line. Chris Kelly made the tackle on that one. Colorado facing a third down upcoming. First four drives.
Haven't done much, have
they? Not much at all. They have one third down conversion so far, and that was in this drive that's now carried them 60 yards. Third down and a long three here.
Key play of this drive was that fake field goal pass.
Yep. They'll run Johnson again. This time Polk's got him all wrapped up, and there's going to be maybe a decision to make here. I don't know if Gary Barnett even wants to think about anything other than a field goal attempt, but they're about a yard short of the first down.
Locking it up inside. Polk just slides from his middle linebacker position. That Polk is a tough character.
And I think the decision's been made, Bob.
Way to go for it.
Yep. Yeah, here's your first gamble, if you want to call it that, for Colorado.
I think he's had a couple others. Yeah, the opening good. Kickoff.
And the fake punt.
Pass from punt formation.
They're a 50% team on fourth down. Andrews, I don't know. Put his head down and put 240 pounds down. And the referee says first down. Don't even have to look at it.
No doubt about it.
And Colorado goes on fourth and one and picks it up. 9:07 remaining in the half. They trail 17-0 and try to get on the scoreboard. Andrews, who was playing linebacker earlier this year, they finally switched him back to offense, which is his original position that he came to Colorado as. And Gary Barnett said the second time he was playing offense, the light came on over his head, and he's been a heck of a fullback since. Machete now from the gun. Mike's got time. Going to go to the corner of the end zone. Overshot the intended receiver. That was Cedric Cormier over there. Incomplete.
That was good coverage. Just a two-man route. Only the two wide receivers were out for good pass protection. A little simple roll. Double tight end. Eight guys in blocking. Two wide receivers are going out, and he just covered. That's, you know, he just throw it out of bounds.
Keel Craver, perfect coverage.
Come back and play again.
There's the red zone for Colorado this year.
That's pretty good.
Machete wants to throw back to the left after the pump fake to the right, and the screen just never materialized. He had to just get rid of it.
When you play man coverage like Nebraska does, you're locked in on the screen guy. The linebacker who's supposed to cover the man they're screening to is right there in his pocket.
So now they find themselves right back in a third down situation. They've got a 16-play drive going, but it's third and 10 again. Trying to find something that'll work offensively. Yeah. Cortland Johnson has done quite a bit of the work as a tailback on this drive. But
you're playing against one of the best defenses in the country, and there's not a lot that's going to work.
Javon Green and Marcus Stiggers both to the right side. Machete going to throw to the end zone and overshot. Javon Green, coverage again was Cravers, and it's fourth and 10.
He had a shot. He just threw it a little bit high, a little bit behind him. Machete's looking up to see. Now, maybe Green should not have come in this far. Maybe Machete was thinking that he was going to stay upfield. That ball is a little bit behind him, but maybe Machete, in practice, they always ran that a little bit wider. You don't know.
Jeremy Aldridge will try to get that goose egg off the board for Colorado from 33 yards out. And he does. So Colorado finally on the scoreboard. They gambled on a fourth down, picked it up. It led to 3 points, but they still trail by two touchdowns.
It was a lot of work. As we mentioned, the two fourth downs you see there, one of them came from punt formation. They had to get a pass. Another one was fourth and one. They barely got that. A lot of work. This is a tough defense we're going up against.
So Aldridge, they just hit the field goal, set the kick away. Joe Walker and Randy Stella way on the other end. Stella backpedals, goes over his head, and he'll have to take a knee 5 yards deep in the end zone. Our Aflac trivia question for this week: which Nebraska assistant played and coached here at Colorado? We'll have the answer coming up for you in a few minutes. At the 20-yard line now, Nebraska goes back to work offensively. First time They had the ball after the opening onside kick by Colorado. They had it right at the midfield stripe, and one carry by Dan Alexander got him a touchdown. And then Eric Crouch ripped off a long run, and Alexander ended up finishing the next drive from 2 yards out.
Pretty soon, Dad. Watch that tight end, Wistrom.
That's right. They haven't used him yet. He's a big play threat. Bobby Newcomb in motion. Play action. They're going to try to come back to Newcomb. Knocked away. Rashidi Barnes. Nice coverage. And he got a hand on it.
And a poor decision there by Crouch to try to complete it. Should have thrown this ball away. I mean, there was... What you're going to have is a play action. This is his number one guy, but the second guy that he throws the ball to is out here on the outside, which he should have never thrown the football. Or throw it out of bounds. Don't try to complete that one.
Alexander now bowls his way, and he's into the secondary. Dan Alexander, the foot race. I think he's going to win it. All the way, touchdown, Nebraska. Ben Kelly never gained a step on Big Dan Alexander.
Alexander is 245 pounds, only 6 feet tall, and Kelly couldn't catch him.
Dan Alexander has come out and had two huge runs, two touchdowns worth 130 just on two carries.
Sykes, the linebacker, number 7, had a shot at him. And Kelly's about 5'10", 190 pounds. Couldn't catch the big man.
So Nebraska warming up the North Division of the Big 12. They can't start thinking about San Antonio yet, but boy, they have taken a giant step in that direction. Last week, fumbled on his first carry and didn't play the rest of the game. His confidence had been close to being shot, and today he's got 8 shots for 151 yards and 3 touchdowns. And Nebraska leads 24-3. Kick goes behind Ben Kelly. Gary Barnett looking on and hoping that his team can get back in this football game. Just when they edge back and finally get a field goal, things start looking good. And then all of a sudden, 80 yards later, it's another touchdown. 7:59 remaining. Special guest, former national champion coach here at Colorado, Bill McCartney. Mac, we bring you in at a great time, don't we?
This is not a lot of fun.
You know, you were the guy that sort of made Nebraska when you came in here, the red letter game. Tell us how that came to be. It kind of had Big Ten roots, didn't it?
It really traced from my experiences as a coach at Michigan. When we played the Buckeyes, it was so challenging, so demanding, so rewarding that I wanted to share that experience with every kid. And, of course, you have to build the program up to get into a game like this.
I know you had a chance to talk to the team the other day, didn't you?
Yes, I spoke to them Wednesday night and just shared a little bit of the history of how that game got to be red letters.
The North Championship trophy of the Big 12 is here in Boulder somewhere as Andrews, the fullback, gets a carry off the left side. I know there was some writing probably on that trophy a lot of people don't know about, and we haven't even talked about yet. You had a chance to see it. That was part of your speech, though, as well, to the team, wasn't it?
Well, they brought that out. I didn't know it was there, and they already had Nebraska's name inscribed. I don't know how Kansas State would feel about that, but they've already counted this one in the Big 12 office.
Gary Barnett in his first year. Coach, I know he enjoys having you around the program, obviously. Maybe after this play, you can give us your opinion on how Gary's done so far. Here's Machete on the roll. Got the corner. Mike puts his head down and gets a first down. Out at the 40-yard line, a pickup of 12. Craver made the tackle over there, but Colorado keeps the drive going with 6:46 remaining. Gary Barnett, your impression of him?
Yeah, well, Gary worked with me for several years, and he's a complete coach. He's really has the kids' best interests at heart. He relates to them well. He's a good game day coach. He proved that at Northwestern. Back-to-back Big Ten championships at Northwestern. That's testimony to the guy's ability to coach.
First down for Colorado at the 6.5 minute mark from their own 40. Machete, the play fake, and throws a streak, and it's knocked down. That's just playing great coverage by Ralph Baum, because if he doesn't get a hand on that, Javon Green takes it about 60 yards for a touchdown.
Exactly. You got everything they want. Got inside release. You got plenty of time to throw the ball. Ralph Brown gets beat to the inside, and now when the ball gets there, good vision and good athleticism just to knock it down. Had everything he wanted. If he catches the ball, he's got a touchdown.
Right. Second down at 10. Green out for a breather. Stiger's the lone wide receiver. They'll keep it on the ground at Cortland Johnson now to pick up of about three. It'll bring up a third down and 7. Coach Mack, can Colorado get back in this thing today?
They're playing very conservatively. They're trying to keep third longs out of the game plan, and I don't know if they can with that strategy, quite frankly. Nebraska's just made a few big plays. They really haven't been consistent on offense, but defensively they're so good, I just don't know.
We're going to wish you the best. Thanks for stopping in. We'll let you go down to booth down to our left and enjoy the game, Coach.
Bill, it's always good to see you.
Bill McCartney, national championship coach here at Colorado. Hauls in a third and long pass down to the 37-yard line, and that's a first down for the Buffaloes. Well, Hollowell's been kind of their big play receiver today.
Hollowell's probably the smallest guy on the field. Here he is here. He's just going to come down to the inside of the field. Shetty with good time to throw, steps up. Ball's a little behind him, but now you get to see what the quarterback sees from behind him. It's hard to see out of that hole back there. Boy. Machete's about 5'11". Not an easy thing. It's easier to see from up here.
On the ground is Carrington. And he got about 2. Boy, that was a heck of an adjustment by Hollowell on that pass to get that first down. Carlos Polk made the tackle. So 5'11", and the clock running. 24-3, Nebraska. You know, you said coming in, we talked about it earlier, I guess, Nebraska would like to win impressively here, go to the Big 12 championship, win impressively again. That's all they can do in the whole BCS situation.
That's all they can do, and that seems to be what they're doing.
And a 2nd and 8, Johnson runs into Warren, and down he goes. Got about a yard. Third down and long coming up again. Coming up tomorrow, some more great football. Interstate rivals go head-to-head on ABC. Some of you's
my man, Joe Hamilton.
Boy, what a
66%
season.
Of his passes, 25 touchdowns, leads the nation in pass efficiency. Getting it done, and they say you don't have to be too tall. Yep. You can get it done. It's his size. Come on.
Goes 5'10". If he's lucky, high snap. That one too high for Machete. He picked it up on a hop, though. And has to take it out of bounds. Nobody down there in the pass pattern to speak of after that one sailed over his head.
Yeah, this defense of Nebraska's is tough enough without helping them out by doing silly things like this. Poor snaps from the center. The ball just going to go over his head. Center Gerard just hooks it and hooks it high over his head. And Machete just does the good thing of just running out of bounds. He wanted to throw it, but there was nobody down there.
Didn't want to make matters any worse
than
they already
were.
Nebraska has nobody back.
And everybody covering the gunners on the outside.
Right. Each in punt formation. Kicks it a mile in the air. Colorado looking to cover it inside the 10. Are they going to get a shot at it? They stumble as they try to get it near the goal line, and Fred Jones couldn't find a handle. 44-yard kick, and they'll bring it out to the 20. We'll bring it out right now. John Saunders in New York. John, feel a little bit better. The Aggies at least did it today.
Yeah, yeah, didn't they?
And all our thoughts and prayers with all of the folks involved in the tragedy down in College Station. First down, Nebraska. And the fullback Miller goes for about 6 straight up the middle. They're using Willie a lot as a running back today.
Nebraska got a real break starting on their 20-yard line instead of on their own 1 or 2-yard line. Jones, number 13, knocks that ball into the end zone. All he had to do was slap it back into the field of play. He had plenty of teammates around, and you saw Gary Barnett just shaking his head. He says, you know, somebody's need to make a play. We can't keep helping. Bad snap from center. Don't do the right things on special teams. Got to start playing smart.
There's a fumble. They put it on the ground. Colorado says they have it. Officials don't indicate yet.
Now they do. Yep.
Now they do. Well, that was almost what Bob was just talking about that Colorado was looking for.
Can't tell from there. He did, the quarterback just never got it, and then he did get it.
Yeah, got it right under his chin.
Crouch didn't get it from the center, and then he got on it.
He covers his own fumble, the three-minute mark. That's seven. Nebraska hasn't needed to throw much today. They won't hear either. Crouch will keep it. Open field for Crouch. He's over 100 yards on the ground again in the first half, and he's got a first down out at the 43-yard line.
Crouch is just going to run the option down here, and this time he's going to keep it.
Never hesitated, did he?
But look at the blocks he got. The tight end is here. The other guy, the two wide receivers are there, and he's just going to break right up behind him. Look at the blocking downfield. Wistrom is one of them.
First down out at the 43. Bobby Newcomb in motion. He'll give it, though, to the eye back, Buckhalter. And he hangs on to the ball as he got almost four. 24-3, Nebraska. Earlier we asked you our Aflac trivia question, which Nebraska assistant coach played and coached at Colorado? We've given you time. It's Charlie McBride. Two-way end in the late 50s, and then a grad assistant here in the mid-60s. And speaking of 60, just turned 60 last weekend, had a birthday party for him. A lot of people think that this might be the last time he'll coach in this rivalry between Nebraska and Colorado.
Well, he just keeps saying how old he's getting, how tired he's getting.
His back hurts.
Back hurts. Yep. I said, Charlie, how you feeling? He said, I'm feeling pretty good now.
9-1's not bad.
That's
if they can win this one, win the next one. And
that's right.
And then win a bowl game, he'll feel even better.
When your defense is ranked in all the categories in the nation and in the top two or three, you got to be pretty good about that.
First penalty. There's Charlie. Stalking the sidelines. Top 15 and 13 of his 18 years as defensive coordinator. Bob mentioned the experience on the staff. They've got 145 years of experience on the Nebraska staff. Crouch keeps this one, too, and he got collared from behind. Could have been a bigger gain, but Warren stuck there with him.
And this is what Colorado had in mind, somebody to pressure the quarterback, stretch it out, and then don't let him pitch it and contain him inside. That time, Walruz and the defensive end were right there to tackle him.
Yeah, the tackle was Tyler Brayton, not Jesse Warren, 99, not 98. Third down, 11. Well, last time they had a third and long, they didn't even think about putting the ball in the air. They just ran Crouch on the option and let him go. Let's see what they do here from their own 43-yard line. He's going to call a timeout. That's Nebraska's second timeout. And we got a timeout here so we can check in with John in New York. John, and part of that halftime that John and Terry will have involves that young man, Greg List. Nebraska backup. Defensive back, who's a second-generation player and is the spitting image of that first generation, his dad, Jerry.
Yep.
He lost his mom and dad, and just stick around for that. You want to talk about a Thanksgiving story that'll touch your heart.
That's a good
wait
one.
For that one. At the 42-yard line, Crouch has had a chance to talk it over on the sideline, and Gary Barnett's team in a 21-point hole here in the final minute of the first half.
Even though it's 3rd and 10, Colorado's playing it like it's a rundown. They may go after, they could hit Wistrom here, the tight end, right down the middle of the field.
Crouch, straight drop, sets, goes deep for Newcomb. And almost intercepted by Ben Kelly, and Ben saying, I should have had it.
Yep.
Overthrown just a bit. Newcomb may have prematurely jumped, and Ben Kelly almost pulled that thing down.
Kelly on Newsom. It's a good matchup here. Colorado thinks that Kelly can get it done, and he does. He's all over him. If the ball had been thrown more across the field to our right side, away from Kelly, maybe Newcomb could have run to it. But as it is, Kelly almost gets the interceptions. He's got 5 on the year.
And he'll just stay back there where he broke that play up as he waits on the punt return.
Frank Solich says that we're not going to punt the ball to Ben Kelly.
Let's see if Hayden Felt can keep it away from him. Ben's going to try another one from the four, and he goes down at the five. Fell on his own, trying to make a cut, and they are buried in a hole now. 54-yard punt, and only a one-yard return. ABC Sports presentation of college football, brought to you by you. Takes a lot of guts for somebody to run a shop like that, but he sold a lot of stuff here, even on a daily basis, in fact. That's apparently the story. The Big Red of the Rocky Sports Shop, though, it's in Estes Park, Colorado, which is, maybe 40 minutes up the road from here. Open year-round. Today's the biggest shopping day of the year, as everybody knows. And they've got a little bit of everything in there. Gail Novotny's got everything from Barbie dolls and pieces of turf to Christmas cards and autographed football helmets. And as I said, I give Gail credit. He has got some kind of guts to sell red and white stuff here in gold and black country.
Hey, I tell you, you can tell in a minute who you're rooting for by just looking at the crowd. If you've got any red on at all, Colorado players and fans do not wear any red at all.
Right now, Colorado only seeing red because third-ranked Nebraska all over the Buffaloes, 24-3 at halftime from here in Boulder. As we send it back to New York, John and Terry. Guys. Welcome back to Boulder. Brad Nessler and Bob Greasy. Partner, I don't know if it was an omen of things to come, but Ralphie won't run today. But Nebraska is. They got 288 yards already in the first half.
One of the best parts of coming out here is you get to see Ralphie run. I love to watch the Buffalo, but he's not running today. 288 yards, and that's the story. Colorado cannot stop him, and offensively for the Buffs, Machete is not in groove. He's only 4 of 14 for 39 yards, and that's their meal ticket.
Morgan Stanley, Dean Witter, first half statistics bear out what Bob's talking about. Only 70 yards in the air for Colorado, and that is a season high allowed by the Colorado defense to anybody on the ground this year, and it's all come in the first half. You saw Dan Alexander on the sideline thinking about what he has ahead. He's one of two Huskers over 100 yards on the ground. He and Eric Crouch both have that much in the first two quarters.
Well, Crouch has 107 yards rushing, and Alexander 151 and three touches.
Dan Hayden failed to start the third quarter with the kick. You saw Ben Kelly back there waiting on it in the shadows of the goal line. They've been trying to keep it out of his hands. This time they're going to kick it the other way, and Damon Wheeler takes it on one hop. And Wheeler, the other cornerback, if you will, on the special teams, gets it out to the 26-yard line as we check in with Steve down on the sideline.
Brad, talking to Coach Barnett coming out of the locker room after the half, he said it's pretty obvious what he needs to do to get this team back in the game. Score three touchdowns. He wants to do it by the defense getting turnovers and the offense making big plays. Conversely, Frank Solich of Nebraska says he wants his team to start this game from scratch, establish dominance, beginning with the opening Colorado drive, stopping them defensively.
They certainly have done that so far today, and they will set up shop at the 26-yard line. Andrews, a fullback in motion. Machete, a little bit of option the other way. Late pitch and a dangerous one ball loose. Nebraska's got it. Tony Ortiz with a fumble recovery.
See, desperate teams do desperate things. When you're not up to the playing as well as your opponent, and Colorado cannot stay up with Nebraska, you do an onside kick on the opening play of the game. You do the option, but you're not really used to do it. You have to try things. And Barnett knows that if he wants to stay in the game, you've got to do some of these things. And the timing wasn't there. He faked it. He double-hitched the pitch. Nebraska sees the option all the time. Colorado doesn't run a lot of it.
So the first play of each half, disaster strikes Colorado and sets Nebraska up in great shape offensively again, this time at the Buffs 31. Here's Crouch on the option, and he'll keep it. Nice job stretching it out there. Rashidi Barnes gets over to help on the tackle. Alexander, as Bob was talking about, 151 yards and three touchdowns. He started the game with a bang. First offensive play for the Cornhuskers, 50 yards for a score. Eric Crouch then had a long run of 35 yards that set up Alexander from 2 yards out. That made it 14-0. And then 80 yards.
Power and speed right here. Look at this.
Track man trying to catch him. Wow, what a half.
245 pounds. He outran the little defensive back.
Here he comes again. Bounces off a tackler and gets ball loose. Colorado's got it.
Yes.
Right at the very end, and it's scooped up by Jayshon Sykes. There's the fumble problems for Nebraska again.
He doesn't cover the ball up, Brad, when he gets into traffic. When you're going to get hit, you need to put both arms over the ball. He's still running like a tailback, slashing and cutting in the hole when you should be covering the ball up when you're going to get hit.
Well, they've lost two of the four they put on the ground today. Here's another one.
Take a look at this. Nice hole right up the middle. Gregorik right there hits him. Right there. See, he goes over and he doesn't have two hands on the ball. The helmet gets in the right on the football. Got to cover it up.
So Colorado a chance. And timeout. Boy, nothing's going well for the Buffaloes. Penalty markers all over the place as well. Let's see if they got the timeout call before delay a game, if that's what the call was.
Timeout, Colorado, prior to the penalty. Timeout.
They'll give them the timeout. We'll take one as well. Not quite a minute into the third quarter. Steve Warren and that Nebraska defense has stuffed Colorado all day long. And now the Buffs, though, with the Cornhusker fumble, get it back, first down. They run a draw play. Johnson, and still only got about a yard. Jason Lohr made the tackle. I think Steve Warren, we talked about him earlier, Bob. He's had another whale of a game.
One of the top defensive tackles in the nation. Splitting two blockers and just annihilating the offensive man.
Got just eight tackles already.
Look at the quickness. He's nearly 300 pounds. Got the quick feet and strength to dominate.
Second down and nine. Hollowell in motion. As Machete drops, throws on the run to Hollowell. Let's see if he can get to the stick. Yes, I think he did. Heel Craver right there with him. And Hollowell's been the big play receiver. It hasn't been Javon Green. Hasn't been Marcus Dicker. He's been number five out there. He's got three catches today.
You said big play. That's the only thing big about him.
Yeah, that's true.
He's 5'5 and 160. Outside the pocket. Gets the ball to little Hollowell. And a first down.
Out to the 36-yard line. Green and Stiggers now in there, both split to the left side, and Andrews in motion. And Johnson slips on his own. We've seen that a few times today, some people slipping around out there. Don't forget, tomorrow, Sergio Garcia will compete in his first skins game. He'll join Fred Couples, David Duval, and Mark O'Meara in one of America's favorite Thanksgiving traditions. Skins game tomorrow, 4:30 Eastern, 1:30 Pacific on ABC. Mark O'Meara got about, what, $430,000 at the Skins game last year?
I think he's looking forward to that.
Yep. Second down, 11.
It's an easy money.
O'Meara in motion and the give to Johnson. And he's leveled by Carlos Polk and Kyle Vandenbosch.
Comes around the end. Vandenbosch, from his defensive end position, plays going away from him, and he just down the line and makes the play.
One of the great kick blockers in college football, too.
There's Vandenbosch right here. Watch him as he just trails the play, sees it's not coming, and then that's just great effort.
Three block field goals. He and LeVar Arrington, kind of guys you don't want in the way of your kicker. Here comes a blitz on Machete. Steps up, now steps out of the pocket, gets what he can, and dives to the sidelines to about the 44, a couple yards short of the first down. Run out by Deion Booker, starting safety today. And it's fourth and a long one. So Nick Peach is going to come in to kick it. And Keo Craver drops back. Nebraska anticipating everything. They didn't expect another fake gimmick, but you never know.
That'll slow your rush up when you're afraid they're going to throw the football.
Nice kick. This time they will be able to cover it. Inside the 10, all the way down near the 5-yard line. Excellent punt, great coverage. Nebraska, though, leading by 21. Beautiful day in Boulder, Colorado at Folsom Field, but not so pretty if you're a Buffalo fan. They trail Nebraska 24-3, courtesy of Dan Alexander's three touchdown runs and a Josh Brown field goal. And Colorado's only been able to muster a three-pointer of their own. But they have pinned Nebraska back inside their own 10 on that last punt. Alexander not part of this drive as Eric Crouch in the offense sets up at the six-yard line. We're starting field position of the day for the Cornhuskers. They go straight up the middle, trying to find a little bit of room to breathe. Only got about a yard as we check in with Steve Seifer. Steve?
Brad, with four fumbles today, the Huskers are just about on average with four per game. They've lost two of them. If you take a look at how they happened, it's a variety of situations. Inside, it's just a fumble, a bad pitch here. Can't get to it. Quarterback exchange, no excuse for that in November. And here, Dan Alexander had the ball in his left arm. I don't think he's as comfortable there. The buzzword from Dr. Stark, tuck the football away.
They're forgetting the tuck part. Nice play defensively. Justin Bannon brings down Dan Alexander.
The last fumble that Alexander had in that little piece that we showed you, he was just trying second effort. He had been hit once and had been hit twice, and he was just trying to get more yardage. And that's all well and good, but been doing that, you just have to cover the ball and protect it. Because if you fumble the football, you cannot play this game.
School record is getting closer and closer all the time for Nebraska. A team record of fumbles in a season, 1967, they had 46. Penalty markers down here as Alexander goes down after about a yard gain. The flags all over the place.
The snap, false start, offense.
So that puts the Cornhuskers in a little more precarious position now. They're going to be inside their own five to snap the ball.
We talk about all the Husker fumbles, Brad, and they do lead the nation in most fumbles and fumbles lost, but they have only thrown four interceptions, so they don't give the ball away very many times throwing it, but they put it on the ground. In fact, in the conference, they're the third best in protecting the ball. So even though all those fumbles, they don't throw many interceptions.
The turnover margin still a pretty good one. Third down and 13. Straight ahead to Miller to about the five for Willie. That's it. Now they're going to have to punt, and they're going to be watching their punter have his back foot back there by the pylon. They don't have much room to work. Hayden Feltz a good one, but let's see if Colorado will try to put some heat on it.
A couple weeks ago against Kansas State, he kept punting it away from David Allen, a great punt returner for those guys, but he's got another one here today in Ben Kelly.
They're going to send everybody, it looks like, so he'll have to get rid of it in a hurry. And as Bob said, that could force him to accidentally kick to Kelly without wanting to. End over end job. Kelly's got a hustle and reverses his field looking for the handle, and now he can't ever find the football. And it's a good punt all the way down to the 36-yard line, a 59-yard kick.
Great punt.
ABC Sports presentation of college football brought to you by Jeep Grand Cherokee. The journalism and broadcasting majors come through there. I guess our illustrious producer, Jay Rothman, must have spent a class or two in that building. I don't think he spent a lot of time in class. Ortiz with the tackle. Tony had fumble recovery earlier in this half, and now a tackle there. It'll be second down and 10.
You know, Colorado had Nebraska backed up in their own end zone punting the football, and hopefully they could have gotten some good field position out of it. But with a great punt by Haydenfeld, I don't think we give enough credit to the special teams and especially the kickers for Nebraska. They've done a great job.
Machete, play action, pump fakes, now goes long to Green. He made the catch. At the 34, finally they got a deep ball to Green in front of Ralph Brown.
He's had a lot of single coverage all day. Machete just needs to throw it up and let Green do his thing. Behind the defense, nice pass protection, good vision. One-on-one out here. Green does a nice job of seeing it and going up.
Got about a 4-inch height advantage. It doesn't hurt the cause there against an All-American corner.
And you've got that single coverage all day long. Pretty good cornerback.
Machete looking to throw again. Got one man in front of him. Finally lets go at the last moment. He was being chased out of there by Aaron Wills. And a penalty marker. Did Wills hit him out of bounds? So you're going to call intentional grounding.
Oh, my goodness.
Yep.
Yep.
Machete says, hey, what am I supposed to do? I ran out of real estate.
Grounding. Spot foul. Loss of bounds.
And now, looks like more penalty markers coming way back here on the... Either that or throwing pom-poms from the stands. I thought we had another flag down at the 44-yard line.
He's rolling out, and he's keep rolling out. And look, there's nobody open. There's a man covered. There's a man covered. There's a man covered. The problem is he throws it up here in the way out of bounds. You got to at least make an effort to get it close. Now, you know, that's kind of close there.
That is.
That's kind of close.
The guy that made that catch over in front of the 10-yard line marker is only about 5 yards out of bounds.
You can almost make a case for your momentum carrying you that way is going to carry the ball out of bounds a little bit further than you thought.
Machete, pressure, screen pass. That's blown up again. And a penalty marker now. I hope they don't call the ineligible receiver because he had Cortland Johnson right there. He almost hit him in the rear end with it.
I think that ball did hit an offensive lineman. I think that may be what the flag is.
Now they're also saying maybe it was a tip ball, and that might pick the penalty marker up completely. Let's wait and see. John Laurie will tell us.
Illegal touching by the offense. Loss of down.
Whoa.
See, it's no penalty.
Illegal touching.
It's no penalty if you hit the offensive lineman. It's just it's just loss of down,
right,
which it would be anyway.
You lose that anyway.
Yeah, there you go, right there. It's that hit Bedell, number 76.
Yep. So it did hit somebody. Hit Bedell. Incomplete, loss of down. Really doesn't change the play at all. It's still third and one.
You don't want those small butts up there. You want big butts up the offensive line. I told you that a couple weeks ago.
I know that.
Makes you feel secure.
Machete, plenty of time. Incomplete. And it looked like Cedric Cormier pulled out of that a little bit.
Thinking yeah.
He was going to get leveled.
Yeah, he had something going, and he just kind of pulled out of it. He's going to come down the middle, and he's going to have something in the middle of the field. This is what Machete's going to see. Look at it right here. He's wide open, and watch as he pulls up out of it.
Ooh.
He's looking at the guy coming back.
That's not going to go over big in film study. Nick Peach to punt. The high, lazy kick that Colorado should be able to camp under. Around the 10. Right about at the 11.
Yeah, difference in the punters right there in field position.
Applebee's Game Fact this week. Class of 99. Coaches in new spots. And Jack Bicknell, the second or third, I guess Jack is. La Tech at 8-2. I think June Jones would be my coach of the year pick right now from Hawaii. What a turnaround. And Gary
Erickson.
Barnett. Yeah, Dennis Erickson just signed a new contract extension. And Barnett and Stoops, both from the Big 12, doing a good job. Today it's not going so well for Gary Barnett. Nebraska leads 24-3. Eric Crouch on the keeper. And fumble again. Out of bounds, though. Out of bounds. Jay Sean Sykes made the hit. That one went backwards.
Yeah, this is one of the problems this offense we've talked about are the fumbles. And, of course, the quarterback's got the ball in his hands on every play. Crouch coming down the line. Yep. You know, option, and we talked to Frank Sillage, but he said, we've been fumbling for a long time. You know, we've always had a lot of fumbles.
Right.
We're an option team, and that's going to happen.
And Gary Barnett said the good thing for a lot of their fumbles, they're near sidelines, and you can't get a handle on it. That's what happened on that last one. Now they go back to Alexander up the middle, and Rashidi Barnes makes the stop. It's going to bring up a third down situation.
Colorado's defense is tough, and Nebraska's had 7 plays. They've had about 10 yards in the second half. They've had a turnover, and they've made no first down. So Gary Barnett's defense that has played much better the last 4 games of the year is starting to toughen up here in the second half.
Here's a third down stop they definitely need, 3rd and 4. And they get the stop. In fact, they lose yardage. Andy Peek, who's been in there for Ty Gregorak, who's out with a partially separated shoulder, makes the hit on Willie Miller.
Have they directed a pass toward Wistrom all day?
I don't believe so.
Tracy, I didn't count a ball, I know.
There's Andy Peek. Nice job defensively by the sophomore linebacker.
Nebraska is one of six passing, 24 yards. They've only completed one pass, so they really haven't needed to throw.
Then Kelly waiting on what Haydenfeld has to offer. Last time he got all turned around by Haydenfeld's punt and couldn't get a handle on it.
This is a rocket.
Hits a moonshot here. Kelly over the shoulder catch and slips on his own again. He's down at the 13. He can't get up and run. He put his knee down.
He has slipped every time.
And I think he's done it on his own every time. I don't think anybody's touched him. So it'll be at the 13-yard line for the Buffaloes. Sunday night on ESPN. Yeah, to watch.
He is interesting, isn't he?
Yep.
And you're never out of it when you got him on your side.
First down, Buffaloes. Across the 15, but not much more is Cortland Johnson. And we're down to 6.5 minutes remaining in the third quarter, and it's an awful day for Mike Muschietti, who had such grand thoughts of coming in and winning his last game on this field, and it's not going that way.
He didn't play well against the Huskers over in Lincoln last year, and he wanted to make amends for that. This is one of your better defenses. You're not going to play well against this defense. They're going to get you most of the time. If you can score 21, 24 points, that's a big day.
Muschietti on 2nd and 7 in trouble again. Penalty marker down. We're going to have holding, I'm sure, in the Buffaloes backfield as Carlos Polk brings down Muschietti. And it is a holding call against Colorado. Steve.
Tell you what, Brad. Muschietti can join the club of quarterbacks who have had tough days against Nebraska. Cordell Stewart, as good as he was. Coy Detmer, John Hessler, they've all had trouble against Nebraska in this game in the 90s.
Muschietti, you know, was saying you get judged at Colorado by how you play against Nebraska. And he says, if you look at it that way, Darian Hagan's the only guy that's done worth a darn in the last decade. So
I've done a bunch of those games, Steve, that you were talking about. And Charlie McBride, the defensive coordinator for the Cornhuskers, said the first thing he says, I ask him, what's the game plan? He says, get after the quarterback. Pressure on the quarterback and rattle him, get after him, because that's the heartbeat of the offense is the quarterback.
Let's see how Muschietti does from the shotgun. And a 3rd and 11. Has some time. Incomplete. Intended for Cormier again. And the coverage from Keo Craver. And you may have seen the score roll across at Virginia Tech. Right now shelling out Boston College. Of course, they're number 2 in the BCS. This Nebraska team's number 3. And hoping to move up. But it would take a miraculous play if Virginia Tech keeps that lead and goes on to win that ball game for this Nebraska team to get in that hunt. They got to win this one. And Texas is next up, waiting in San Antonio in the Big 12 championship next week. They gave you a say on ABC.
And this team lost to Texas, too. That was their only loss that would keep them out of playing in that championship game.
Peach. Well, that one was a peach pick.
The difference in the punters has been shown in the last two possessions. Haydenfeld kicking out of his own end zone, kicked 2 great punts, and the other punter, Pete's coming the other way. Now the possession, they start inside the other team, Buffalo's 50-yard line.
What does this game mean to Nebraska? We talked about it when we opened up the game. Well, the Big 12 North standings, Kansas State, after Nebraska handled Kansas State 2 weeks ago, and so they can go to that Big 12 championship game, and can they get any higher than that? Well, that's still yet to be determined. Those are the BCS standings going into today's game, and Florida State, of course, can sit back comfortably and wait in the Sugar Bowl with an undefeated regular season. First down now, Nebraska, after the short punt. Buckhalter, the handoff, the fake handoff, I should say, and Crouch comes out where Sykes brings him down at about the 26, pickup of 9.
For exchange of punts, and Nebraska gains 44 yards. There's a little fake up the middle. Crouch puts it away. Get your fingers over the end of the ball like he does, and put the other end of the ball tucked between your elbow and your body.
Keyword tuck.
Tuck.
Yeah.
That's right.
117 yards for Crouch on the ground. Buckhalter got a first down and almost wiggled free. Damon Wheeler holding on for dear life. Buckhalter, like Dan Alexander, fumbled in the last game the first time he touched it, too. Now, all the I-backs are playing a little bit better, although we haven't seen the third man, Darren Diedrich, who we thought actually was the best of the three the last time we saw Nebraska.
Sometimes when you play a freshman and sit the upperclassmen down and let them watch a freshman get in there,
yep,
that just kind of motivates those older guys, too.
First down just outside the 20. Crouch, quarterback draw. Boy, tough run inside. Crouch isn't the biggest guy in the world. 6'1", if he's lucky, and about 195, maybe 200 pounds, and he just took it right up the middle.
And every time you do that, I mean, this guy's a quarterback. He's not a big 240-pound running back. I mean, you put the heart of your offense. Every time he runs the ball, 27 times he ran it against Kansas State. How many times has he run it today? About 10 or 15?
14 times.
14 times.
And well over 100 yards again. Second and a long four. Crouch tripped and down he goes. Tripped over a lineman, I think maybe Andy Peake.
Is he grabbing his leg or his knee?
Looked like he got kind of whipped by either his own man or maybe Peake, the linebacker. 123 more yards for Eric Crouch today. He would be, if he ends up being the top running back on this team. Now, that'll be hard-pressed for him to accomplish because of Alexander's day today. But if he ends up being the number one rusher, it'll be the first time since Rex Fisher in 1955. And Rex only had 599 yards, so Eric's already well past that. That would be for a quarterback to lead the Cornhuskers in rushing. And he goes down again, and that time kind of got tangled up in the traffic again and may still be nursing what happened on the last play.
He got tripped on the last play, and this time the fullback and the guard was pulling across, and the fullback doesn't get out of his way quick enough. And, you know, we were talking to Eric yesterday. They had a little walkthrough out there. Watch as the left guard pulls and the fullback gets in there, and they just have a little bit of a traffic jam.
Yep.
And Eric was saying, you know, sometimes I get beat up in there. My arm gets sore. My wrist gets a little. Then they call a pass, and he's more running back than he is quarterback.
Brown's hit one today. He'll try this from 37 yards out. Looks like it's right down the middle again. Josh Brown, a couple of field goals today, and he stretches the lead out further. It's 27-3 Huskers. We might have been off to the races.
Yeah. They've kicked that. They've pooched this thing every time to keep it away from Ben Kelly and to use the sideline as their friend in the coverage.
Give another man down there on special teams.
Of course.
Chalk mark.
Yep.
So Mike Muschietti, who struggled mightily all day long, probably the best pass he threw is that one in the sideline streak to Javon Green. And he comes out with pretty good field position to work at the 38-yard line.
Muschietti, 6 of 20 on the day.
Diggers still hasn't caught a pass today. He's in motion. Muschietti looks left, wants to look right, and down he goes. And it's Jason Lohr. Big sophomore out of Jenks High School in Tulsa, Oklahoma with the sack. Let's check in with Steve.
Brad, the reason you didn't see Ben Kelly back to return the kickoff or in the last series of defensive downs is that he's cramping up. It's not anything keeping him, it's not going to finish the game for him, but he's on the bench, stretching, trying to get his legs back under him.
All right, he's a big loss in that secondary for him, obviously. Second down at 15. Hope showing blitz. They back out of it. Muschietti running out of time and penalty markers. They'll blow this one dead. I don't know where that came from. That play was 3 seconds in the making already.
Burn a snap. Ball starts. Offense. 5 yards. Replay second down.
Now, when not many things are going right for you offensively, sometimes you tend to make mistakes, too, against this Nebraska defense that's been so tough all year long and so tough through three quarters of this game.
I'll tell you what, though. Gary Barnett will get this program headed in the right direction.
Yes, he will.
He did a great job, as Bill McCartney said a little earlier. He did a great job in Northwestern. If somebody can come in and turn that program around, take him to the Rose Bowl, win the Big Ten Championship 2 years in a row. Coming out here with this talent, he'll be all right.
Second down at 20. Muschietti from the gun. Fires complete. Nice pass. Out across the 40 to about the 42-yard line to Hollowell again. And the little guy picks up 14 more. So they get back across the original line of scrimmage, where it's going to be third down and about six.
Mike Brown's been kind of quiet today, number 21.
Brown, the hitter of the two Browns, if you will. They'll both hit you, but one the safety and Ralph Brown the cover man on the corner.
And they're both All-Americans. Yes, Mike Brown made one All-American team, and Ralph made another one.
Third down and six. Here comes a blitz on Machete. They pick it up. He lobs it to Stiggers with great speed. Stiggers at midfield. First down and into Nebraska territory at the 32-yard line.
Good call by Tom Cable, the offensive coordinator. You can't get him open downfield, run him across field. Here he is right here, and he's just going to come down and run across, and he's going to get the ball about right over center. Right there, now he's just going to outrun a couple of guys. That's what speed will do for you.
Stiggers, a sub 4-2, 40-yard dash man. It's Tom Cable, the offensive coordinator, looking on. First down for the Buffaloes, just outside the Nebraska 31. Longest play of the day on that last one, and now they go back complete. Penalty marker as Javon Green makes the catch. They're going to call offensive pass interference on him. He is heated as he comes to his feet, I'll tell you that much. He may have said that he pushed off. Now the coaching staff has to carry him off the field.
From behind the defense. There's a separation there. We didn't see it, but Craver, number three, was jamming Green, and Green got the best of, I mean, they were both pushing off of each other. And Craver, the smaller guy, kind of fell back, and that's what the official saw and called.
So that comes all the way back out to the 46-yard line.
Craver's 5'10", 190 pounds, and Green 6'2", and 195, and he won the war of the battle, but lost the penalty.
Machete down the middle, incomplete, hit as he threw by Lohr again, and never really got what he wanted on that pass. So the penalty against Green just totally negated what Stiggers did a couple of plays ago.
Exactly. We're talking to the offensive coaches for the Buffs, and they talked about Warren, but they also talked about Lohr, and he's a backup defensive lineman. He doesn't start. Lohr is one of the guys they rotate in.
He's had a good series. Second and 25 now. And again, Machete from under the gun. Pump fakes. Down he goes. And that was Julius Jackson who got it.
Yeah. Well, they try to pump and go, and you don't have time against this defense.
Another look at Machete. Julius Jackson comes flying in there. He was the starter earlier in the year because of injury, and he's played like an All-American when he's out there. End of three quarters now. Third-ranked Nebraska 27, Colorado 3. An ABC Sports presentation of college football will return after this message and a word from our ABC stations. One lonely Buffalo in that sea of red as the Cornhusker fans enter the fourth quarter, their team in front 27-3. Machete on top to Stiggers. And he goes airborne and hangs on. Craver cartwheels him, but little Marcus Stiggers holds on for a pass down to the 33-yard line.
Well, he held on to that one, and you're right, he was cartwheeled.
And it's still going to bring up fourth down and what, 10? Remember, they had 25 to go to pick up a first down. Tough catch.
Oh, for sure.
And so they're going to try a field goal, or at least set up for a field goal.
Yeah. A bag of tricks over there with Gary's got.
50-yard attempt on the way.
Nice.
Aldridge.
Very nice.
Got it. Nice kick. That matches his career long. Colorado tacks on three here early in the fourth. This game will select a Chevrolet player of the game from each team. Chevrolet will make a $1,000 contribution to each university's general scholarship fund. And beginning this year, Chevrolet will also donate two $1,000 high school scholarships. Joe Walker Randy Stella await the kick from Colorado. Aldrich, who just matched his season long of 49 yards, and kicks it deep. Stella from the one. Stella across the 20. And up to about the 24-yard line. That's where the Huskers will go back to work after we check in New York with John Saunders. John.
Brad, time for the Burger King play of the day. Inspirational if you're a fan of Texas A&M. Randy McCown here, 14 yards to Matt Baumgartner. And following a week of tragedy where they lost the lives of 12 students, they pull out the win against Texas 20-16. Meanwhile, Virginia Tech and Boston College, Tech with a 24-7 lead, and an eye on your game. Brad.
All right, here it's 27-6, very similar scores. And the teams number two and number three in the BCS playing here at the same time. Crouch, play fake, wants to go deep down the middle. And incomplete. Damon Wheeler had excellent coverage out there on Matt Davison.
It's only the seventh pass that Nebraska has thrown. They've rushed the ball 39 times. Really don't need to throw the ball when you're running it as well. Take a look from behind the defense. There's nobody in the middle of the field. There hasn't been anybody there all day.
Crouch completed his first pass, Bob, and he's been 0 for since. Yeah. Second down and 10, but as you said, they haven't moved much through the air. They've got it all on the ground. Two tight end set here, and they'll try to do it on the ground again. Buckhalter out to the 28, maybe the 29-yard line. Time winding down, under 14 minutes remaining. Colorado needs a stop. They need a turnover for a score. They need something just to give them a spark of hope.
They need a score from their defense is what they need. Yeah. They need a fumble that they scoop up and get in or something like that to get them back in this game quickly.
They need a Ben Kelly type play, and he's back in there, as Steve said, battling cramps, and he keeps moving his leg out there. It's still bothering him. He's out on the near side. Now third and five. Inside one will not get him the first down. And Colorado's defense does their job. Walrus makes the tackle, and Nebraska's going to have to give it up.
Colorado needs a block of a punt or a punt return. I just don't think that their offense is good enough to score against that black-shirted, which they're called black shirts, defense of Nebraska.
Ben Kelly is saying, okay, you got it. He's trying to run off the problems with his legs, and he'll send Hollowell out there. It was really Ben's decision, apparently. They were both standing there, and he finally said, I'm going to the sideline. You take the punt return. Hayden Felt to kick inside his own 20. End-over-end punt. Hollowell's been the main. He's been the main receiver today, and almost fumbled that one away. 50-yard kick and no return. We'll return in a moment. We've got 12:30 remaining in the fourth quarter. At a Boulder, Estes Park, the historic Stanley Hotel. Remember that one from The Shining when Jack Nicholson said, here's Johnny.
Oh, boy.
Little kid walking around. Red room, red room, red room. We're going to be red run today for Nebraska. That's the way it's going so far. Machete wants to throw a screen to Stiggers. Boy, that was dangerous. Something could have been picked off. Stiggers made the catch, but only got about 2 yards. The red run today has been courtesy of Dan Alexander. His first carry, 50 yards down the sideline. Bulls his way to the end zone for the touchdown. And then after Eric Crouch got him close, he took the other 2 yards in. Now watch this one. 80 yards with a track man trying to catch him and never gained an inch. Ben Kelly giving chase, part of Dan Alexander's 3 touchdowns today. That's pretty much the game summary as Nebraska leads 27-6. Machete in trouble. Warren's got him. Way back at the 5. Boy, you can tell that senior is not done playing football.
And Machete's not having much fun.
Steve Warren drops him back at the 6-yard line.
There he is. Steve Warren, he's a bull in there. Quickness, look at the quickness. 305 pounds. Just throws him aside.
We asked Charlie McBride the other day, is he the best guy you've had at that spot? And he said, no, you know, Danny Newman is probably the best pure guy there. But you talk about effort and how he's improved in this senior season. He says, Steve's playing as well as anybody we've had in here. Here's Cortland Johnson, breaks three into the secondary. Out across the original line of scrimmage and all the way out to the 23-yard line. Best run of the day for Johnson, 17 yards. But it was a third and 22. That's the bad news.
Yeah.
So time to punt again for Colorado. They did nothing with that last possession again.
This defense for Nebraska just...
You know, playing against the Nebraska defense is like going to court against Judge Judy. Just plain nasty. You know, you're not going to get anywhere.
They're nasty and they'll hit you.
That's right.
Does she hit you? I don't see Judge Judy very
often. She does everything but, you know. Peach to kick. Craver comes up at the 40. Ooh, he took a pop and ended up going back at the 40. Sneed with a nice play on the special teams.
Well, let's look at the tail of the tape between Nebraska and Virginia Tech. In the BCS poll, 2 versus 3. The computer averages are right there, very close. The big difference right here is the strength of schedule. Virginia Tech's schedule is 66th. And, of course, the one loss for Nebraska against Texas is really what is keeping them in third place and not in second.
Also, there was a judgment made this week that the Division I AA playoffs that James Madison's involved with won't have a bearing on the computer or the BCS rankings. That was something Roy Kramer and the guys of the BCS had to take into account because they had not considered ever a team with maybe a shot at a national championship playing a team like that top club.
There. Yeah, well, the only reason it's close is because of these two teams right here, that those are non-conference games. And then right here you've got two other teams with big-time losing records. But the ones that you can schedule yourself, the James Madisons, the UAB, the Clemson and Virginia are legitimate non-conference games. But those other two games, that's what weakens their schedule.
Shovel pass inside of Bobby Newcomb, fumble. Colorado looks like they might have gotten on top of it unless it was blown dead. Umpire, I think, is saying Colorado football. Yes, it is. The Buffaloes have it back.
Well, this is a forward pass, which was ruled complete and then a fumble.
No doubt it was complete. Newcomb took a couple of steps after the catch and then coughed it up.
Sykes hits him. The ball looks like it does come out before he hits the ground.
Here's another angle.
He's bobbling. You don't want to do that. You don't want to be bobbling when you're running inside those big guys. See, never. Yeah, no. His knee may have been down.
Boy, it was off the close.
But you never want to leave it up to the decision of an official.
One fumble short of a school record, they just as soon avoid. Here's an end around to Stiggers. Might be an option to pitch it back to Stiggers too, but he keeps it and goes to the 40-yard line. He had Cortland Johnson trailing him, but Stiggers got 8 yards. It'll be second down and 2. 9:20 left. Colorado needs points in a hurry.
Newcomb doesn't want to, you know, he's still a quarterback. He's an athlete, but he was quarterback originally. And I was asking the question, is he blocking like the receivers at Nebraska normally block? And he said, well, he's learning. And you talk to him and he says, well, that's one of the things I'm working on is my blocking downfield.
Michele play action, wants to throw a streak down the sideline. Got green. Out of bounds at the 14-yard line. First down, Buffalo.
Yep. That's the thing they should be doing. They wanted to do that. They've got away from it. 5 or 6 or 7 times a game, throw that pass right there.
This one's perfect.
It is. Machete has plenty of time, and he has good vision. Sees well. Can't do it any better than that. Good coverage, just a nice throw.
So first down at the 14. 3 catches now for Green.
Green's had 4 touchdowns in the last 2 games. He's been their big play guy.
Machete now under center. Cormier on the move. On first down. Play action again. Throws to the end zone. Man there. John Minardi for the score. And the Buffs aren't quitting. They were buried in a hole against Kansas. Kansas State and almost dug themselves out. They've got a deeper hole here, but they're still in it.
And again, the thing that sets up the score is the short field, the turnover by Newcomb, and then a nice play by Machete.
Aldridge point after. Up and good. With 8:47 remaining in the ballgame, Mike Machete says, I'm not even taking my helmet off. Get me the ball back. He just got it to Minardi and cut the lead to 27-13. Remember that fumble by Bobby Newcomb set up Colorado 47 yards away, and it took him only three plays and 47 seconds to cover that territory. The last 14, Mike Machete to Minardi, his wide receiver, and the half's improving, that's for sure, for Machete. He's not done yet. Kick coming, and now they shift into an onside kick formation. We didn't think they'd do it this early, but apparently they will. Aldridge set to kick it, and he goes down the middle with it. They don't onside kick. Stella from the 11-yard line. Andy Stella looking for an avenue, and he goes down at the 30.
Let's go back to the touchdown. Minardi is right here. He's going to go down and run a corner, but it's the motion that helps him get open. Minardi comes off the line of scrimmage, and he runs right by this corner right here who's looking at here. And the other corner doesn't get back quick enough. That's Ralph Brown. So it's back in the corner. Good planning and scheming by the offense. Tom Cable and his group.
There was an illegal procedure penalty call on that kick. Illegal formation against Colorado, and not a happy Buffalo coach in Gary Barnett. Although they came out of the onside kick, they were called for the penalty. Declined by Nebraska. And the Cornhuskers start from their own 30. So really no difference than what you saw, the return by Stella out to the 30-yard line. Now the Buffs defense needs to come up with something.
They have at least four guys on each side of the kicker.
They show blitz. They shift on the front against Eric Crouch. And Crouch gives it straight ahead. Only about a 2-yard gain for Dan Alexander. Now there's hope for Buffalo's fans, because this half, Nebraska has been stalled, Bob.
They've been held without a first down five of the first six possessions.
So there was no need for an onside kick with 8 minutes, because there's what Bob's talking about.
Right,
one
there.
First down and 41 yards.
Two turnovers.
Deshaun Sykes has one of those fumble recoveries. Ben Kelly's a guy that's taken two fumble returns for touchdowns this year. They'd love to see Nebraska pop another one up. Second and eight. Crouch. Hits. Alexander goes down in a heap of black jerseys. Walrus is the first guy there.
Just good defense.
Third and long coming up. And slow to get up. Russ Hochstein, the right guard.
Guys in the pit, 97 is Bannum, and Warren is in there. Jones and McDonald. Lewis is 31. He's keeping his feet. Walrus gets the first hit. It's good defense. Good team defense.
Third down and six. They will get it. They're going to have to give it back to the Buffaloes.
Nebraska offensively has gone very conservative. But the flip side of that is Colorado's defense has really toughened up here in the second half. And I don't blame Nebraska for playing it conservatively either. Frank Solich, he knows he's got one of the best defenses in the nation. They're hard to move the ball on. He's got a great punter back there. Just play it conservatively and let your defense win it for you. You've
Hayden
got enough
Phelps
points.
Has already averaged 56 a punt today, and it's Hollowell, not Kelly, back there again. Second time he's been back there in punt return situations. Oh my goodness. Maybe too good a punt. It was. It hit the
trees.
It hit the end zone on the fly 64 yards later, but they'll bring it out to the 20. Colorado's defense, they did their job. Now it's up to the offense when we come back.
Yeah.
defense team's got the ball back. They trail by two touchdowns, 6:23 remaining. There is the Big 12 North Championship Trophy we talked about earlier when Bill McCartney was along with us, and it already is inscribed with the name of the University of Nebraska. That was sent to Gary Barnett's office here in Boulder. If I was a Big 12, I'd be a little more judicious on how I sent that trophy someplace in years to come.
Yeah.
They've used it as motivation. Here's a throw.
Look at this. Look at this.
And some room to run for Green down the sideline. Knocked out of bounds. Penalty marker comes flying in. Will we have an illegal block? Boy, the coaches in Colorado sideline are hot. It's a 28-yard gain, and Clint Finley is the guy that knocked him out of bounds. Flag came flying in at about the 33-yard line. Oh, there was one mad coach right now.
Yeah, there was. That was a well-designed play. What did he say? Face mask. They had a lot of room to run outside, and Finley got back over there. Roll one way, been doing that all day. Nice design play. Throw it back. Now look at all of the
There's the holding right there.
Was the face mask. Yep.
Holding on Brian Shaw, or holding against Brian Shaw, I should say, the linebacker who was trying to get out there to blow that play up.
And Gary didn't like that at all.
I don't blame him. Instead of a big gainer and some new hope in this football game, it's first and 17 back at the 13-yard line. Now they've got trips to the left, and Hallowell comes out of that triple set in motion. Machete lofts one for Green. Incomplete. Craver was covering, and Javon Green is saying, hey, the guy's going to let me off my pattern.
Green was being jammed off the line of scrimmage, and that's what he's complaining about. Gary's still upset about that last call. There's only a few plays. There's only a few plays that you call at right times. And he called that last play to get him downfield, and he did it. It worked, and he got him up to midfield almost. And then it was taken away from him by the holding call.
Second down at 17. Charrington checks in to flank Machete in the shotgun. Four wide receiver group for Mike. Straight four-man rush by the Cornhuskers. The pass completed. And out across the original line of scrimmage, Eric McCready, who hasn't played much today, picks up 6 yards.
Machete now is 14 of 30. For almost 200 yards, and he seems to have gotten his got a hot streak going here. He scored on the last drive. Need another score.
He needs some more heat right here.
Yep.
Third down and 7. And motion. The right tackle, Victor Rogers, I think, came out of his stance. Aaron Wills went blowing by him. And this might make it third down and 12. Steve Warren, the defensive captain, one of them looking on there.
Prior to snap, the defense was in the neutral zone first.
Oh, it goes against Wills. Take it back. So Wills in the track stance, jumped in that neutral zone. Victor, I apologize. Victor Rogers back after being out a good majority of this season with an injury. Returned today to be a starter on that right side.
A lot of good offensive linemen come out of here in the last couple of years, too. Both these schools, as a matter of fact. I think that in the NFL right now, there are 6 offensive linemen from both of these schools.
Third down and 2 now. Machete rolls, throws on the run. Hallowell's got another catch. Slips, was trying to get to the sideline. He got the first down, though, I think by about a foot. Of course, the chains on the other side of the field, but the linesman over here with the spot he gave him, and it is a first down.
Yeah.
That's his third catch for Hallowell on third down of his 5 catches today.
He needs to be a little more height so he can get some more leverage. He's so short to the ground, only 5'5".
He doesn't have far to fall.
That's right, but that's the good news.
First down at the 31.
Bad news. Falls a lot.
That's right. They keep the drive alive. Under 5 minutes. Machete's going to throw long down the sideline. Tipped away by Ralph Brown. Nice coverage.
I think you're going to have a late hit on the quarterback.
Machete still down on one knee. Mike Brown let him have it. Mike was rushing. Ralph was covering, and you're right. The two All-American DBs, one was on one end, and one was in the quarterback's chest.
15-yard penalty. foul. Roughing the passer, 15 yards, automatic first down.
I know Mike Muschietti will take this one.
Jack Laurie, one of the better officials in the league. I don't know. That's kind of close. I don't know how you could have pulled up.
Maybe it's a fact that it looked like he used the crown of his helmet a little bit.
That's
I don't know.
True. I wouldn't mind that being caught. I think you have to protect the quarterbacks a little bit more than we are. And I know they're doing a lot to do it, especially in the NFL. But, this business with concussions is really a concern.
At the 46 now, Colorado still has life. Muschietti throwing a deep out. Green's got it. Anna Brown's at the 40. Another Colorado first down. Mike Brown run him out. The Buffs got something going, but is it too late?
And Machete's got his act together, and it's because he's got a little bit more time to throw.
Move the sticks.
Good pass protection. Got three guys on Warren. That's about what you need.
Right. Mike Brown takes his frustration of that last penalty out on Green, doesn't he,
though?
Kaboom.
And that's a good hit. He was in bounds when he was hit.
Muschietti on a hot streak. Admits he's a streaky passer. Play action. Time for him to throw again. Incomplete. Broken up by Brian Shaw. Coming up next Saturday, conference championships and automatic BCS bids are on the line. First, 3:30 enter in Alabama, taking on the Florida Gators' key battle. And, of course, they battled to a one-point game the first time around. We're looking and hoping for more of the same next Saturday night. I hope you join us.
That's a good running back right there.
Boy, is he ever. Colorado four wideout group again, 4:37 remaining. They trail 27-13, but they're fighting back. Muschietti down the middle. Broke the tackle. And inside the 25 to the 22. 18 yards down the middle. Mike Muschietti not giving up.
Well, they went to zone coverage. Minardi's right here. He just got to get into the center of the field and hang around. Wide open because nobody's covering man-to-man and mixing the coverages up. Lots of time to throw. A little momentum here going for the Buffs.
Minardi, two catches this half. One, of course, a 14-yard touchdown the last time they had it. Now he's got him a first down inside the 23 of Nebraska.
And if Nebraska has any hope of getting back, being up to number two in the BCS, losing these points at the end of the game probably won't help them.
Muschietti. Pressure from the backside. Got it complete. Courtland Johnson. Pulling out the down. Johnson inside the 10. All the way to the 3. But again, a flag down in the middle of the field. If this is against Colorado, Gary Barnett's going to eat that headset.
Now, I think this is going to go against Nebraska.
That's what the Buffaloes are saying. Pass interference. Doesn't matter. It's first and goal.
Well, this is going to happen when you get further into the route to the linebacker on the inside. Just going to knock one right here. Right there, that's what he calls the linebacker just knocking the guy off his route.
Muschietti and Minardi and some of the offensive players asking for quiet in front of 52,000 plus. They're 3 yards away from making this a one-touchdown game. Cormier in motion. Play action, Muschietti, almost tackled, now to the end zone, incomplete. Daniel Graham slipped, he threw it behind him. I don't know how Muschietti kept his balance.
I don't either. It was a great play on one end by Muschietti just to keep his feet.
And Julius Jackson's the guy that was chasing him, and he's shaking up. He may have pulled something just trying to get to the quarterback.
Here it is again, number 50 to the left of your screen, Julius Jackson.
Great job by Muschietti.
Great play there, and now you need another great play at the other end, and it can't come through.
What this injury to Nebraska does is give Muschietti and the offensive coaches time to talk it over on the sideline. And Julius.
Well, he may have gotten the wind knocked out of him because his elbow went right up against his rib cage, and he fell right on that area.
Well, Tom Cable had some final words for Mike Muschietti, and out comes the Colorado quarterback with just under 4 minutes left, trailing by 14, but you can see how close they are to the Nebraska end zone. Hollowell sets up in the backfield with Johnson, and now will be in motion. Muschietti again rolling, in trouble, lofts it to the end zone. Graham, touchdown!
Muschietti's hurt.
First catch of the day by the tight end, and it's good for a touchdown, and they're a point away from being within seven, and Muschietti being helped off the field. That one was just a wing and a prayer by the quarterback.
It was a Hail Mary. He was getting tackled, and he just wanted to get rid of it. It was a Hail Mary.
Jeremy Aldridge in for the point after. Dramatic turnaround in this fourth quarter. Shades of the Kansas State game. To try to make it a seven-point game. And it is. Don't go anywhere. 3:51 left. There's life in Boulder at Folsom Field. And there's still life in the Buffaloes. Thanks to a gutty quarterback and a prayer answered in the end zone. Left. And during that timeout, they were working on Mike Muschietti like a group of red ants at a picnic over there, hoping they can get that elbow and that shoulder ready for one more shot.
Yeah.
If they get the ball back.
Well, he's a tough kid. I mean, that won't hold him back from coming back in. The big thing here is now getting the ball back.
80-yard drive capped by a 3-yard touchdown Hail Mary. And Daniel Graham made the catch. And now last time they faked the onside and kicked away down the middle. This time they've got everybody set up on the left of Jeremy Aldridge. You would assume this is where they will try it. 3:51 remaining. Colorado has used one of its timeouts this half. It hit him. One official said Colorado and still does. The other says Nebraska.
Yes, you're right.
One official, you can see on the top of your screen.
He was wrong.
This one, Colorado's got it.
The one inside was wrong. One was one way and one was the other. The ball hit Davison in the chest and bounced off of him. If Davison gets out of the way, the ball goes out of bounds and up into the stands.
Watch this. The line drive hits Davison. Boom. Right in the shoulder pad. And then Wheeler, number two, was there to cover it.
That's Brown. Mike Brown that was hit. Mike Brown was hit.
You're right. Davison was the guy that was trying to cover it.
He was going after it.
Colorado's got it. They've got Mike Muschietti glued together at the 44-yard line.
And here they come.
Muschietti running out of time. Breaks the tackle. Into the clear. Muschietti inside. First down, Colorado. Somebody forgot to tell the Buffaloes they've been corralled.
Somebody forgot to tell Muschietti that he wasn't playing well. He woke up in the second half and has brought this team back.
We told you he's got a little bit of Jim McMahon in him. He's got a whole bunch of Muschietti in him right now. He's Muschietti-ing his way through the Nebraska defense.
And a very good defense in that. You're not going to get them all the time. They're going to get you some of the time. You just want to get them a little bit of the time.
First down at the 34. Cortland Johnson into the clear. Johnson inside the 20. And another Colorado first down. Pickup of 17 more.
Isn't college football something? Momentum can change so quickly. In the pros, you don't see it change as quickly, but a couple things happen. Young kids are involved, 17, 18, 19, 20-year-old kids. They think they've got a chance to win, and now they're down in there ready to tie the game.
They trail by seven. Clock winding down to 3:20. Minardi. Cormier and Stiggers, the three wideouts. And now Cormier in motion. First down for Mike Muschietti. Immediate flag goes down. He throws, and it's incomplete. And he's popped pretty good by Eric Johnson as he let go of the pass. That flag came immediately in the backfield of Colorado. It's a motion call against the Buffaloes.
And that's only a 5-yard penalty. And they may decline it. I think they'd rather take the play.
The machete looks to the sideline. Frank Solich, a look of concern on a coach that had this game well in hand. It appeared. And that appearance has definitely changed. They led 27-3, did Nebraska. But 17 unanswered points by the Buffaloes, and you see the fist of Mike Machete as if to say, all right, guys, we're still very much in it. Let's keep on moving it.
You know, Brad, there's a common denominator here, and it goes back a few years when we were doing Big Ten games for Nebraska, for Northwestern, and Gary Barnett was the head coach. And there was never any quit in that team. They'd always come out, and they would do things that looked very similar to this team at Colorado right here.
First down and 15. Machete sets, fires to the end zone. Green's there. Got it. Touchdown. Machete to Javon Green for 21 yards. And we're a point away from a tie game. Couldn't have been put in a better spot. Aldridge for an all-important point after. We are tied up. Guts and guile of a quarterback play in his final home game, Bob Greasy.
It looks like, again, the motion of the receiver coming in fools one of the two defensive backs. These guys don't know which one's going. This one goes to the outside, and the corners get kind of confused. And a great throw by Machete to get it to the outside.
This pass could only be one spot, and he found it. Gary Barnett, who's put new life in this rivalry, knows what it's all about. And looks out almost in disbelief that he is tied up at 27.
They came from nowhere. They were out of this game. They were beaten. And now it looks as though the defense for Nebraska looks beaten and tired and confused.
It was 27-3 at the end of the third quarter. Then just 43 seconds into the fourth quarter, Aldridge kicked a 49-yard field goal. And you said, why'd they go for a field goal? It's 27-6.
Yes.
Now we know why.
Now the pressure is back on the guys in the red and white.
Man, is it ever.
And Kansas State has awakened. Because if Colorado wins this game, Kansas State goes to the Big 12 championship game next week.
What a gutty show by number 4 in this half. He just kept hanging in there.
A warrior. You got to get beat up and beat up and beat up by a terrific defense. But if you just hang in, your chance will come and your time will come.
Now there'll be a kick straight away. They don't need it onside here. Plenty of time left for their defense to do its work, and he hammers the kick. Stella has to take it 7 yards deep in the end zone. Nebraska will work from the 20. ABC Sports presentation of count left, I think. And maybe Ralphie staying in his pen both at the beginning of the game and at halftime. That was a good one.
Ralphie didn't want to run.
Nebraska's offense is stalled. Colorado's defense fired up.
Is alive.
The crowd is electric. We're tied at 27. Nice play fake by Crouch. Downfield and finally goes to Wistrom when they need him. First down out to the 32-yard line. The first time they've thrown to the big tight end.
First time they've used him. First time they needed to throw. It looked like Frank Solich was happy just running the football. Here he is here, just going to come across the field. Play action on first down. Going to open the offense. The problem here is their propensity to fumble. If they put it on the ground here, it could be devastating.
Absolutely. Power eye behind Crouch. Another play fake. Here it sets up and going deep for Wistrom. Overshot him. Nice coverage back there by Michael Lewis, the strong safety.
Very interesting. The whole game, when the thing was in hand, they just ran and they didn't look at Wistrom. Now when they need to win the game, the first two plays go to Tracy Wistrom. He is a big play guy. He came in to the game with 15 receptions, averaging 27 yards per catch.
Including a 70-yarder, one of his two touchdowns this year. And now a three-wide receiver offense for Crouch, and he'll work from the shotgun. Second down and 10, Nebraska. Quarterback draw. Eric goes straight up the middle, put down at the 34. And it's going to be third and about eight.
Gary Barnett was telling us earlier that the defense, I think Colorado's taking a timeout.
Yep. But
he was telling us that the team weren't running together at the beginning. He says he came in, it was, you know, no continuity. We talk about continuity all the time. Nebraska's got continuity in their coaching staff. 145 years on the staff. Colorado didn't have that. So the players who finished 16th last year in the country got a new coaching staff come in and they started doing things differently. New terminology. He said, hey, we did it all right the way we did, but there was some trust that needed to be built up, and finally, they believed in each other.
They're starting to believe in this fourth quarter. First, Minardi from 14 yards from Machete. Then he lofts one in the tight end. Has the answer on the other end. The onside kick goes off Brown, covered by Wheeler, and then Machete going deep. Javon Green in a deep out, got it in the corner, and it's 27-27. And the quarterbacks, the Dell Game Solutions, they have both played very, very well.
Well, and in their own way.
Right. You said they were completely different.
Different. And Crouch has 118 yards rushing. And now Machete finally, after some poor numbers, Mike stayed in there. You got to get beat up on this defense. They're going to beat you up. But finally, Machete got him.
Nebraska's missed their last six third down conversions. They've got to have this one. Crouch, incomplete. They're going to have to give it back.
It's interesting that when push came to shove late in the game, that Nebraska went to their passing game to try to move the ball down the field.
And now Ben Kelly says, let me have a crack at this punter. Kelly has stayed out the last two or three times and given way to Hollowell. Now with 2:10 left, he can feel what's going on in this stadium, and he wants his hands on it. But keep in mind, Haydenfeld's shortest punt of the day was 49 yards. Kelly's not going to be able to track it down, and it goes out of bounds inside the 10. A great kick at the 5-yard line.
Outstanding.
What a job he's done all day.
He's averaged 57 yards per punt, and his counterpart, Peach, averaged nearly 39 yards per punt. That's almost 20 yards in exchange, a punt exchange.
He just hit that one 60 yards and knocked it dead out of bounds at the 5. But number 4 has got his armor on one more time. Mike Machete, who's been haunted by the interception a year ago, he said, I cannot put that play out of my mind. I think about it every day. Here he was getting ready to throw. Clint Finley was on the other end, and Finley picks it off and goes 42 yards for a touchdown. It led to a Nebraska 16-14 win, and he stepped on Machete in the process. But Machete now comes out firing from his own 5, incomplete. It'll bring up second down and 10.
Well, I mean, you want to win the game. That's what they've got 2 minutes to try and do that. But at the same time, you don't want to turn it over either. This Nebraska defense has gotten the ball 39 times. The defense has given the ball to the offense and the opponent's 50-yard line or better.
You make one mistake against this group, and this game could be over in an eye blink.
That's so true.
Machete handoff to Johnson. Broke a tackle. Portland Johnson gets him some room to work. He lost the football.
There it is.
Craver's got it. Nebraska ball. He just took it away. Mike Brown stripped it. Keo Craver's got it.
That's the fifth time this year that Mike Brown has forced a fumble.
What a heartbreaking way if it's going to end that way for Colorado.
broke right there. It doesn't make a very good effort. Mike Brown right there gets a good grip on it and is pulling for it and comes out.
Nebraska doesn't have to do anything as you get another look. Mike Brown just rips it out of there. All they want to do is stay in the middle of the field for Josh Brown, unless a touchdown comes without trying. Crouch. The pitch. Fumble! Colorado's got it!
I can't believe he pitched it. I cannot believe that he pitched it.
Unreal.
This is where they've had all their problems. If you're going to run the option, let the quarterback keep the ball. Don't pitch it. That's where you had your problems.
And setting Josh Brown up for a field goal, I talk about, looks pretty good right now, doesn't it?
Yeah, it sure does. This is not Crouch's fault. Alexander just does not catch the football. The throw was there.
That ties the school record for fumbles in a single season by Nebraska, and it gives Gary Barnett's Colorado team the ball back.
How many fumbles is that today for them? Seven, and they've lost four.
Machete, draw play, Johnson, quick opener. Colin Johnson across the 30. Johnson with Julius Jackson trying to track him down, and finally they get him at the 42-yard line. Pick up a 27.
This Nebraska defense is tired. Colorado has run 81 plays. This Nebraska defense is tired.
Cortland Johnson has just been biding his time. The runs have been getting a little bit bigger every time.
Guys,
any bigger than that.
Defensive players that were getting off of blocks early in the game are getting blocked now and not getting off the blocks.
Tell you what, if you've ever even gone jogging out here in Boulder, it's not the easiest thing just going for a nice run out here. Nebraska might be suffering from the altitude a little bit. That pass nowhere near the intended receiver. Javon Green was out there. Let's check in with Steve.
Brad, you talk about Mike Machete and his courage, and I don't think you're understating him when you talk about this guy. He's listed at 5'11". He's not 5'11". Before the season began, he was upset that so many times a year ago he was injured and he couldn't be on the field. He said in August that it's going to take a stretcher and somebody's going to have to put him on it to carry him off the field in this season. The guy played baseball. He's a tough kid in every sense of the word. And the first one he'll blame is himself.
Stretcher's about the only place he hasn't been today. Comes up throwing again. And Minardi made a great catch. He's still on his feet inside the 25. Minardi somehow turned all the way around and caught that ball.
Unbelievable.
The catch of the year for Colorado.
Unbelievable. Going to come break to the outside. The ball's going to be thrown over one shoulder, and he's going to twist and look the other way. Look at this. He looks back to the inside. That's just a great adjustment.
Catches the back end of the football. What a grab.
Now, they do this in practice all the time, but to do it under pressure in a game is something else.
A pickup of 35. First down, Colorado. Charrington in at tailback. He'll get the call. He gets to the 20. Tony Ortiz holding on for dear life. Clock at 35 and winding down. Colorado's only got one timeout left. Machete looks up there. Tie game. A field goal would win it. It would send Kansas State to San Antonio against the Longhorns of Texas. The wind a little bit in their face, although it swirls in this stadium, could have an effect on a kick that might be upcoming. 24 seconds left in regulation play in a game that had third-ranked Nebraska leading Colorado 27-3 at the end of the third quarter. But the fourth has belonged to number four, and Colorado's got a chance to win it.
Here's a look at Machete. Only 39 yards in the first half. 17 of 27 and 267 yards. Three touchdowns. He's come alive in the second half.
This is an official timeout. Colorado still has one remaining. Brad Bedell is the injured player, the All-American guard who's being helped off the field, and now he says, I'm going off under my own power. And Mike Machete is saying, we're on Buffalo power right now. What stopped Nebraska? Turnovers, turnovers, turnovers. We've been talking about it. We've been harping about it for the last two games, Bob and I have done. And today it cropped up on them again. Seven fumbles, including one a couple of minutes ago, that has given Colorado the chance they had. Charrington, on the inside handoff. Got it to about the 16. And now the clock will wind down. They're going to put it on the foot of Jeremy Aldridge to try to win it. Timeout. The final one. We've got one play left at Folsom Field.
Gary Barnett, first year back in Colorado, makes a big deal of the Nebraska game, puts the pressure on his kids, and they come through to get it down to this point.
The entire state of Kansas, especially the city of Manhattan, is looking at the 1 second remaining, and they are cheering for a senior kicker from Federal Heights, Colorado, named Jeremy Aldridge. That tells the whole story right there. Aldridge last year set a single season school record with 16 field goals. He's hit a couple today. He can again hit his 16th field goal of another season, but this one would be a milestone for him, and it would send this place to a frenzy and send Kansas State to meet Texas, and Nebraska's Northern Division championship of the Big 12 would go by the boards in a game we never, ever, ever expected to come down to 1 second. It has. Timeout taken by Nebraska now. And there's Vandenbosch just kind of circling. He's got three block kicks this year, two in a single game. We saw him block one 2 weeks ago. He's a guy that'll go airborne up the middle and give up every part of that body to try to get to the football, and you can bet that's coming up here in a moment.
It's a tired Nebraska team, defensively especially, as I mentioned. Now 86 plays, the defense have been on the field.
Time permitting, stay tuned for the Thrifty Car Rental postgame report. Scores and highlights from across the country with John and Terry. I never thought I was going to lose my voice with 1 second left in this game. I thought I was going to have enough to do a doubleheader. Aldridge, 2 for 2 today from 33 and 49. Has not had a field goal block this year. From 34 for the win. Kick on the way. He missed it. We're going to overtime.
Unbelievable.
Overtime in Boulder. And a huge sigh of relief in Lincoln and all over the state of Nebraska. Here's another look.
He just pushes it to the right. He's been drawing these balls in. He's been a little hook on them. This one just starts right and stays right. It was close.
Now it'll take Machete to get the football back to give him another chance. We've got overtime in Boulder, Colorado when we come back. Tied at 27. Mike Machete hoping that his offense can be successful. Of course, you start thinking touchdowns here and the coin flip, all of that. You would prefer to play defense to open up an overtime session. So the coin toss with John Lurie is all important here as Mike and Ralph Brown will anchor the captain group for Nebraska. And let's go down and find out who's going to get it first.
Gentlemen, shake hands. You had a good hand.
Good game.
All right, Colorado's the visitor. We will call the toss. If you win the toss, whoever wins the toss will have a choice of playing offense, defense, or choosing a goal. Heads and tails. If I drop it, we'll toss it again. What's your call?
Tails.
Nebraska calls tails. It is tails. All right, Nebraska chooses to be on defense. Which end will we play from? We'll go this direction. You have 1 minute. Good luck, man. We'll start in 1 minute.
So Colorado will have the football first. An ABC Sports presentation of college football in overtime will return after this word from our ABC stations.
Team gets equal possessions, and the thing is, you start on the opponent's 25-yard line going in. And if it's tied after each team gets a possession, then you do it all over again. You can make first downs and whatever, but you want to go on defense to see what the other team's offense does so you know what you have to do.
That's exactly it. One timeout each in overtime. Nebraska wanted to start on defense first for the simple reason Bob just mentioned. They know what their offense will have to go for. Field goal. After Machete and group's done.
Field goal kicker here is a big plus. Good defense and a field goal kicker.
From the 25, Machete, a toss to Cortland Johnson. Follows his fullback. Got inside the 20. Kept his footing. Mike Brown brought him down at about the 17, maybe the 18-yard line.
And there is no hurry here. The clock is not even on. They just go until somebody wins. Boy, what the emotions that have been involved here in the last 15 or 20 minutes. Colorado coming and catching up. Mike Brown's fumble recovery, forced fumble. Then the Nebraska giving it back up.
Second down and three. Cortland Johnson again. Don't think he got the first down about a yard short. Kyle Vandenbosch made the tackle. Keep in mind, Colorado has an overtime win this year. They beat Missouri back in early October, 46-39. So they've been in this situation before this year, and that doesn't hurt either.
That's true. That's very true.
Third down and an all-important one right here. Nebraska's object, stop them right here, force the field goal, give it to your offense with a chance to win. Stiggers in motion. Third down and a yard. Fullback Andrews. I don't know.
I don't think so.
And now Nebraska saying that they have the football, but no indication from the officials that way. Mike Brown made the initial hit.
I think the ball may have been loose. No, you got to put three on the board. You got to go for the field goal.
So they are a yard short. You can see it right there.
Yeah.
And Gary Barnett says, Jeremy, you didn't get the last one. Go hit this one.
Yeah.
So he missed the final play of regulation from 34 that would have won it. Now he's trying to give his team the lead in overtime. It's going to be very much the same spot, as a matter of fact. This will be a 33-yard attempt. Aldrich has a final look up to try to give Colorado the lead in overtime, and he does. Right down Broadway. Colorado leads 30-27.
Now the pressure is on Nebraska. A team that leads the nation in fumbles and fumbles lost. If they drop one here and lose the fumble, they lose the game.
Simple as that. They have today tied a school record for fumbles in a single season. It was set back in 1967.
And if you're Frank Solich calling plays, you've got to take that into consideration. I mean, you've got to think that Alexander's been my big man today, but he's also fumbled a couple of times, not caught the ball.
Kansas State can only sit and watch.
Oh, yeah, they're pulling for the guys in the black shirts right here.
Are they ever? Nebraska, if they can pull this out, they'll go to San Antonio to meet Texas for the Big 12 title. Crouch drops back to throw. Now throw short over the middle. It's caught by Davison. Not a very big game to about the 21-yard line that he swarmed under. I thought that Crouch wanted to go deep on the first play.
He did. He did, and he pulled it back. This is tough to ask Eric Crouch, who hasn't thrown a lot of balls all day, to come out and out try and win at throwing the football. Crossing routes, top left, guys are running into umpires and everything else. Came off and just dumped it off.
That Tracy Wistrom running a post pattern, couldn't get it to him. Came short for 4 yards to Davison. Second and six in overtime, Colorado by three. Alexander blasts his way straight up the middle, and he's 3 yards short of a first down. Rashidi Barnes made the tackle.
This defense for Colorado has really shown up here big in the second half.
Now the Colorado defense will try to come up with one more big play and force a Josh Brown field goal attempt and put all the heat on the Nebraska kicker.
Yeah, this Colorado defense has only given Nebraska one field goal in the entire second half. Something Gary Barnett said coming out. Defense has got to hold them, and the offense has to come alive.
Third down and a long three. Willie Miller has got a first down. Down to the 12-yard line. They go straight ahead with a fullback, and he's been a very effective weapon straight up the middle today.
Yes, he has. Doesn't carry it very often, the fullback, but normally when he does, he can get something. Now, if you're Frank Solich, you got to feel like, I got three in my pocket. I got three in my pocket to tie. Now I want to go for the touchdown to win. The worst thing to do, I don't want to lose. I don't want to drop the ball.
Exactly.
No turnovers.
Keep it in your hands no matter what type of play it is. Crouch will give to Alexander.
Pops inside the 10. Alexander to the 1 yard line.
Almost won it right there.
He's a bull.
He has played huge today. Had the great first half with 3 touchdowns. And he is ending the day the way it began.
Yes. Everything is, hold on to the ball. Right there, the ball could have come out. A helmet, another helmet. He never puts that other arm over the ball to protect it.
First and goal about 2 feet away from the Colorado goal line. Nebraska with a chance to go to the championship game. They are there. Touchdown. The officials unpiling bodies signaled touchdown as Crouch went in from a yard out.
Penalty is declined. The touchdown
penalties
is good.
On the defense. It's a touchdown, Nebraska. They're going to San Antonio. They've got a little bit of revenge in store, maybe, for the Texas Longhorns. What a game.
What a game. What a great game. Great rivalry. If this is what Gary Barnett wants, he's got it.
He's got it. Dan Alexander, 3 touchdowns today, but it was Eric Crouch, their undisputed offensive leader, who just got enough a push inside. And it's touchdown, as you can see. Nebraska goes to the Big 12 title game and wins its 10th game of the season for Gary Barnett. A gallant and brilliant effort by his team in the second half came up short.
And I think another team that must be smiling right now is Virginia Tech.
Our Chevrolet players of the game. Mike Machete, an unbelievable performance by the Colorado quarterback, and Dan Alexander, who had around 190 yards in rushing. In recognition of their effort, Chevrolet will make a $1,000 contribution to each university's general scholarship fund. Beginning this year, Chevrolet will also donate $1,000 to 2 high schools. That's the kind of feeling if you're sitting on the Colorado side of the stadium. But obviously the jubilation is on the side of Nebraska and their coach, Frank Solich. He's with our Steve Cyphers on the field. Guys.
Coach, did you have it drawn up this way?
We had a lot of momentum early in the game, put points on the board, and then all of a sudden, as the second half came about, we just got a field goal, but we started losing the momentum, and then all of a sudden, it was a great football game and came down to the wire.
You got to win.
We got to win, and we'll take that. Certainly, I think Colorado's a very good football team. Our kids played very, very tough, and I think in order to come back like they did in the overtime, showed tremendous character.
Coach, thanks. Congratulations. Take care.
Final score in overtime, Nebraska 33, Colorado 30. This has been a presentation of ABC Sports, a continuing tradition of excellence.